Hello and good morning to everyone. My name is Shahid Karim and you are welcome to our second session on online talk series by ECE Department of the Education University of Hong Kong. I'm a postdoctoral fellow at the Early Childhood Education Department, the Education University of Hong Kong. As you know, today we will be using two languages for our communication during the session. So I will be helped and we will be helped by two our team members from Cambodia. One of them is Mr. Sok Sok Hom, Chief of Planning and Research. Education, Ministry of Education, Youth and Sports, Cambodia. And the second one is Ms. Lee, EC Coordinator, Faculty of Education, the Royal University of Phnom Penh, Cambodia.
Okay, good morning, Shahid. Alfredo, they got you Sastra Chan Hong Kong Nang Mong.
My name is Sokom and I come from the Early Childhood Education Department, Ministry of Education, Youth and Sport. Chumbiep su all over the Ngoknia, Kyum Mopi Yotan Rukumato, Chmu Sok Sokom, Hai Chi and Trey some Robs and Rule, Kang Knight Obrukumato, Chamuin and Sakov Shai from Ping Ba, some.
Thank you. So what we are doing today and offering one of the workshops online series is under the project Cambodia Early Childhood Education Project. And the main purpose of these talks and series is to share the knowledge on early childhood education with our Cambodian stakeholders. So let me introduce our today's speaker, Dr. Alfredo Bautista. Dr. Alfredo Bautista is an associate professor and associate head internationalization in the Department of Early Childhood Education at the University of Hong Kong. Dr. Alfredo has earned degrees in psychology, music theory, transposition and accompaniment and piano performance. He studied at the Universidad Autónoma de Madrid, Spain for his PhD degree in psychology.
Dr. Alfredo,
Dr. Alfredo is genuinely an international scholar and a global citizen. He has worked and lived in several continents, including Europe, North America, South America, and Asia, and countries including Spain, the UK, the USA, Canada, Argentina, Singapore, and Hong Kong, China. Dr. Alfredo's research interests include teacher learning and professional development, instructional practices, and early childhood education. Dr. Alfredo has won many research grants and secured funding from international agencies in Singapore, the USA, Canada, Spain, and Hong Kong. Currently, he is undertaking several research projects as a principal or co-principal investigator.
អញ្ចឹងនៅគោលគោលសម្រាប់ការស្រាវជ្រាវគាត់គឺខ្ញុំដោតទៅលើគរុកសលការអភិវឌ្ឍកុមារតូចដូចជាការអភិវឌ្ឍវិជ្ជាជីវៈរបស់គ្រូក៏ដូចជាវិជ្ជាជីវៈផ្សេងផ្សេងហើយការងារប្រជើងរបស់គាត់គឺពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងត្រូវក៏ដូចជាការអប់រំសិល្បៈនិងការកើតថ្មីក៏ដូចជាការលេងរបស់កុមារ
Good morning everybody. My name is Dr. Alfredo Bautista. And I am associate professor and associate head in the Department of Early Childhood Education here at the Education University of Hong Kong.
Okay, good morning, Alfredo. My name is Dr. Alfredo Bautista. I'm a professor of the Department of Early Childhood Education in the Department of Early Childhood Education in Hong Kong.
It is really a pleasure to be here this Saturday sharing a little bit of my knowledge with you on music education as part of the Cambodia Early Childhood Education Partnership, in which we have been working already for a couple of years with our partners from Cambodia.
រៀនមតិសិក្សាដែលជាសកម្មភាពជំរុញឲ្យកុមារធ្វើការរុករោសម្រាប់ពុកលោកនឹងហើយក្នុងការចែកលេខនឹងគឺធ្វើឡើងក្រោមសហប្រតិបត្តិការរវាងសាកលវិទ្យាល័យភ្នំពេញនិងសាកលវិទ្យាល័យអប់រំហុងកុងលោកគ្រូ
And the title of the presentation today, the title of my sharing today, as you can see here, is Music in Preschool Classrooms, Activities for Children to Explore the Sounds of the World. So I really hope that you will enjoy my presentation and we'll get good ideas for your classrooms.
អញ្ចឹងនៅគោលគោលសម្រាប់ប្រធានបទនឹងតន្ត្រីក្នុងការអប់រំកុមារតូចដែលជាស្ថានភាពជំនួយការរករបស់កុមារនៅក្នុងសំឡេងពិភពលោកនឹងគាត់នឹងធ្វើបទបង្ហាញហើយក៏សង្ឃឹមថាអ្នកគូលគូពេញចិត្តក្នុងការធ្វើបង្ហាញរបស់គាត់ហើយប្រសិនបើអ្នកគូលគូមានអីចង់ចូលរួមចែករំលែកគាត់នឹងទទួលយកដូចគ្នា
My students in class know that every time I start my class, I always like, especially my music education class, I always like to start with a song. And then I also like to end my class, especially in music education, with another song. So like every time I'm going to play for you a hello song, how are you today?
នៅពេលដែលមកគាត់គាត់តែងតែចាប់ដើមព្រមជាមួយនឹងចម្រៀងដែលតាក់ទងនឹងសួស្តីឬក៏ស្វាគមន៍មុននឹងចាប់ដើមមេរៀនហើយក៏ពេលបញ្ចប់ក៏គាត់នឹងមានចម្រៀងផ្សេងទៀតដែរដើម្បីលឺគ្នាអញ្ចឹងណាលោកគ្រូគ្រូ
For those of you who are early childhood teachers, for those of you who work with children in preschool, try to find similar songs to start your classes also.
អញ្ចឹងសង្ឃឹមថាអ្នកគ្រូគ្រូដែលធ្វើការនៅក្នុងវិស័យអប់រំពិសេសនៅខាងកុមារតូចនឹងអាចស្វែងរកជំនឿដែលប្រហាក់ប្រហែលដើម្បីតាក់ទាញចំណាប់អារម្មណ៍របស់កុមារក្នុងការរៀនដូចគ្នា
We begin every class with a how are you today song. And the gestures that I use for the song are happy, sad, and hungry. But please feel free to make your own gestures and have fun with the song.
Sure. So I begin every class, as the presenter says, always trying to start with a song, try to find a song that your children like. That will be an indicator that this is the beginning of the class. It is a very important way to start the day and to indicate to children that this is time for learning. Welcome, everybody. Let's start our learning today.
Okay.
So let me give you a little bit of some information of what I am going to discuss with you today in this workshop. I would like to start talking a little bit about the role of music in preschool education. Then I will be talking about the talk is going to be focusing on something specifically, which is related to the development of active listening. So I'm going to be talking about mainly about listening activities. And then I will be talking third about sound and musical creativity. How can we use sound to create and produce music with sound?
So
today I would like to keep the workshop as practical as possible. We are doing this workshop online, so it's not very easy to be very practical, but I will try to show you many videos, many examples to try to illustrate some activities that I would like to propose. So as much as possible, I'm going to try to give examples of activities that you could do with your children in Cambodia, and examples of how we can incorporate these ideas in our class, and also suggest some teaching resources that you could use.
Okay.
After that, I would like to have a short break, take a 10 minutes break or something like this. And after the break, I would like to continue talking about listening and propose a sequence of how we can work with our preschool children in our classroom. How can we incorporate a sequence of activities to guide our perceptive listening and really how to incorporate activities that can be meaningful in the classroom when it comes to listening and analysis, right?
And
finally, I will be also sharing a few more ideas for lesson ideas that I think can be useful to foster creativity in your classroom, right? And finally, we will end with some question and answers at the end. Any questions that you would like to ask, we'll be very happy to discuss.
Okay, hi, Samrat.
All right, so let's get started, right? So I would like to start with a question, right? So with a question for everybody in the room. We are 129 people connected. So if I say to you music in preschool education, what comes to mind normally? If I say just what do you think about if I say music in preschool education?
Okay,
normally, when most teachers think about music in preschools, they normally would think about two main things. Number one, they would think about children singing songs, like the song that we have seen right now. And also sometimes teachers would think about playing musical instruments, like the instruments that you can see here.
អញ្ចឹងជាធម្មតានៅពេលដែលយើងនិយាយពីតន្ត្រីក្នុងអ្នករៀនកុមារតូចហ្នឹងយើងនឹងគិតដល់រឿងពីរយ៉ាងទី1គឺតកតងនឹងថាឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងច្រៀងចម្រៀងនៅក្នុងថ្នាក់ហើយទី2ហ្នឹងគ្រូគាត់នឹងគិតទៅដល់ការដែលឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងលេងឧបករណ៍តន្ត្រី
So sometimes in some schools they would do much singing because singing is easy. Singing doesn't require any materials, any resources. But sometimes in many preschools, including in many preschools in Cambodia, teachers don't have all of these instruments. So sometimes children cannot do any instrumental music simply because they don't have the instruments. So in the end, the only thing they do for music in preschool is really singing.
គេតែងគេគិតថាឲ្យសិស្សឈៀងនឹងគឺជាសកម្មភាពមួយដែលងាយស្រួលដោយសារតើត្រូវបានអនុវត្តច្រើនឲ្យសិស្សឈៀងនឹងដោយសារតើវាអត់ត្រូវការឧបករណ៍អីច្រើនទេគ្រាន់តែឲ្យសិស្សប្រើតែមាត់ឈៀងអញ្ចឹងណាដូច្នេះហើយមិនជានៅប្រទេសកម្ពុជាយើងពេលច្រើនអនុវត្តសកម្មភាពឲ្យសិស្សឈៀងជាជាងឲ្យសិស្សប្រើឧបករណ៍ផ្សេងផ្សេងក្នុងការលេងជាតន្ត្រីហ្នឹងណាអ្នកគ្រូលោកគ្រូ
In this talk, I would like to share an idea that music in preschool education is much more than this. Music in preschool education is much more than singing and playing instruments. There is a lot of more other things that we can do to experiment with sound. That is also a very important component of music and musical creativity.
អ្នកគ្រូលោកគ្រូទីទៀតគាត់នឹងបង្ហាញវីដេអូមួយដែលបង្ហាញពីថាប្រយោជន៍នៃការឲ្យកុមារលេងតន្ត្រីជាងការឈៀងចម្រៀងណាអ្នកគ្រូលោកគ្រូនិយាយថាពេលឲ្យគាត់លេងតន្ត្រីគឺគាត់អាចរុករោអ្វីផ្សេងផ្សេងបានហើយនឹងបានកាត់របស់ថ្មីបានច្រើនជាងឲ្យគាត់ឈៀង
I would like to share with you just as an introduction I would like to share with you this video that I find really interestingIt's called City Symphony by August Rush. And I think it's a really nice way to introduce the topic of my workshop today, which is about listening to the sounds of the world.
Okay. And then, cool, cool. Got clean time video. And then, cool, cool. I chop it out. My boy, we act that tone of the team about that. Got behind the clone thing. I know. And then, cool, cool. Behind the clone video. And then, គឺមានជំនងជាណាសិទ្ធីសិទ្ធីអីគេមិញនេះដែលបង្ហាញដោយនៅក្នុងដូចវីដេអូក៏បង្ហាញតិចតៀងគ្រូលោកគ្រូ
I like to show the video to show that when we pay attention to our lives, we can discover that we are surrounded by very rich and complex sounds that is the basic and the foundation of music, really.
Chúng ông lục sậy về địa bàn khơi video lục sậy khơi sao bách hà nơi về đại dương ban trong từ lơ sầm lên vậy mũi đàn ơi trung bình luôn bao nhiêu mấy cứ dương ai đăng tha và vậy vậy đàn ông nâng nơi trung bình luôn những viên chi ở cái hai tha mũi than cứ này này trùng vạn bọn trùng riêng rồi còn trùng vạn plain như trùng vạn đàn trai đại chi mũi than cứ đàn trai nơi nơi trung bình luôn bao nhiêu từng ông nâng bàn. Okay.
And it is very important that we train and teach our children in classrooms to really pay attention to the sound surrounding us and to really learn how to perceive the sound.
Chúng vì chỉ sự quan trọng đó đại ở lối xoay ai vô tới bằng riêng của mà tôi thà xâm lý nơi trung bình luôn rồi bao giờ nữa cứ ai vô tới chỉ xâm lập với chỉ một thằng là bị phật chia đầm trai bàn và.
So today, basically, my main topic is really about musical listening, right? So before, I was talking about singing, I was talking about playing musical instruments, but music also involves the ability to perceive, the ability to pay attention to sound, and also to create with sound.
Bạn này thay chữ ca đập giang sạc cắm đài xâm rạp chi mù than ca bạc ca nơi đần trầy rư có bạc lật đần trầy ấy nâng môn nâng gọt bằng riêng ông pi trầm biếng rư có đần trầy ếp xênh xênh chân cư vậy để gọt đọc xâm khăn nơi bên ấy cư ca bằng răng nơi ca nơi xâm mặt thiệp nơi ca sạc đập.
Well, as you know, what I'm going to try to explain today is that for educators, it is important to really understand how children develop their active listening skills throughout their development. And because based on how we develop, we can design different kinds of activities to allow our children to become more and more perceptive. So the activities that we can do in the different stages of development will be different.
Chúng con nâng bị chạy chun ở lỗ sấy nơi cầm bật này cả vì vọt nơi cả sạp tờ tam à chủ có tờ tam cầm bật robot của mà tổ chức nằm bay ở lỗ sấy ai đăng thà ta cầm bật nơi cả sạp của mà nâng viên nâng cầm bật ná hay dừng ai riệp chom chia sẻ cả mập hiếp đầm bay ông răng rồi gặp nhốt nơi cả sạp của con nâng càng đầm biên sạp mập hiếp bằng thêm nâng cả con nâng
So, and of course, the activities that we can do with children will be more and more and more and more and more sophisticated as they grow older, of course.
Chúng hai ban chia sẻ cam phép đã dâng thời cật đến cứ thời tam cật tam cầm đặt ở trụ hơi dâng thời cật tha vì ai cần cầm đặt này sự mặt tập hiệp nâng cần đặt tràn tới tam lập biệt nào bạn.
There is a lot of research showing that children, babies, we come to the world ready to perceive, really ready to perceive sound. And children already, when we are born, we already come to the world equipped with very impressive perceptive abilities, really.
Chúng miền cả sọc xa xa chưa tràn nát đại cả nơi trong giới thà sạp chộp nơi này xem xe này cả sạp bọc cổ má hơi away đằng ngon nó cái cả màu pi sạp chộp trong chụp bụi nó sập mặt phía này cả sạp cổ má nó tăng pi công nát màu thêm đồng và.
So when we are born, we are able to differentiate different pitches. Like if a note is very high or very low, children at birth already can distinguish high and low pitches. So come.
Chúng sân ba chi côn không này từ từng cao mà nó cứ ai đằng pi hạ tha ti liên nâng vị ai nhận tha là cúp hoặc là tiếp và.
very quickly children will learn how to identify the voice of the mom very very fast, the mother's voice.
ហើយបន្ទាប់មកទៀតគឺកុមារទារកនឹងអាចរៀនចំណាំនៅសំឡេងរបស់មេដារបស់គាត់នឹងបានយ៉ាងឆាប់រហ័សបាទ
So only at 6 or 7 months children will be able to get a sense of a musical phrase in their own culture, so they will understand very 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 early on, simply having half a year, what is a sense, a musical phrase in their own culture, which is very impressive, right? So and by the 8 months they will really know what is a really melodically complete phrase in their own culture, which is really really impressive.
ចឹងនៅក្នុងកំឡុងអាយុ6ទៅ7ឆ្នាំគឺកុមារគឺមានសមត្ថភាពអាចយល់ដឹងអំពីអត្ថន័យនៃអត្ថន័យនៃចម្រៀងទៅតាមវប្បធម៌របស់ខ្លួននីមួយនីមួយព្រោះអត្ថន័យនៃចម្រៀងអាចដឹងថាមួយឃ្លាណាដែលមានសារៈសំខាន់អីចឹងណាតែនៅក្នុងអាយុ8ឆ្នាំគឺគេអាចយល់អត្ថន័យកាន់តែមែនទែនទៅក្នុងបទចម្រៀងដែលផ្សារភ្ជាប់ជាមួយវប្បធម៌របស់ប្រទេសមួយមួយហ្នឹងបាទ Okay
Very good And then after, when children become a little bit older so they start being able to explain with words what they perceive right So they start developing the vocabulary to describe what they hear they understand musical concepts when they are preschoolers and then when they're in primary they will be able to understand more and more sophisticated concepts musical concepts like pitch rhythm form etc right
ជាងនៅក្នុងកម្រិតអាយុមកចូលដល់មួយឆ្នាំពីរឆ្នាំហ្នឹងគឺគេអាចចាប់ដើមមកតូចហ្នឹងគឺអាចចាប់ដើមយល់អំពីពាក្យខ្លះនៅក្នុងតន្ត្រីហើយអាចបញ្យល់បានថាហ្នឹងវាពាក្យហ្នឹងអាចមកពីខាងណាអញ្ចឹងណាហើយនៅពេលដែលក្នុងកម្រិតអាយុមត្តីសិក្សាគឺគេអាចយល់អំពីគំនិតឬក៏តុងឬក៏ tempo បានន័យថាចង្វាក់លឿនយឺតក្នុងតន្ត្រីហ្នឹងនៅពេលដែលនៅក្នុងថ្នាក់បឋមសិក្សាគឺនឹងអាចយល់កាន់ច្បាស់អំពីគេហៅថា pitch ឬក៏ rhythm ចង្វាក់នៅក្នុងតន្ត្រីហ្នឹងអាចមកពីចង្វាក់រងវងឬក៏ចង្វាក់អីផ្សេងផ្សេងអញ្ចឹងទៅដែលយើងមានតាមវប្បធម៌របស់យើងហ្នឹងបាទ
So many of these achievements are actually natural. Children develop these competencies by themselves without any training, really. So children will just learn how to do these things being exposed to sound. But as educators, we really, as preschool educators, we really need to try to provide children with experiences so that they further develop these competencies earlier and in a more sophisticated way. So this is what I would like to share with you today, activities that can foster this development.
ចឹងអ្វីដែលគាត់បានបង្ហាញនៅក្នុងមួយ slide នេះគឺជាគេថាសមត្ថភាពដែលកុមារនឹងអាចកើតឡើងដោយឯងដោយមិនបាច់មិនចាំបាច់មានការបង្រៀនឬក៏ការបង្វឹកអីទេតែក្នុងនាមអស់លោកអស្រីជាគ្រូបង្រៀនគឺយើងត្រូវមានវិធីសាស្ត្រឬក៏ត្រូវរៀនអំពីវិធីដើម្បីភ្ញោចឬក៏ដើម្បីឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងអាចមានសមត្ថភាពទាំងអស់នេះបានលឿនជាងបានឆាប់រហ័សជាងដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់ហ្នឹងអាចគេហៅថាមានសមត្ថភាពពេញបរិបូរណ៍នៅអ្វីដែលគេបានចៃនៅក្នុងនេះបាទ
Very good So let me show you the first part of this video that really shows how children from babies from when they are born how they are able to respond to sound and how they are able also to communicate their ideas as they listen to sound
ចឹងនេះគឺជាវីដេអូដែលបង្ហាញអំពីទារកមួយដែលគាត់គេពេលនៅពេលដែលគេចាក់តន្ត្រីទៅគឺទៅគាត់មានការឆ្លើយតបយ៉ាងម៉េចហើយការរបៀបសន្ទនារបស់គាត់មកវិញឆ្លើយតបយ៉ាងម៉េចអានេះគឺជាគ្រឹះនៃការសន្ទនាហ្នឹងវាម៉េចយើងស្រីអាចឃើញនៅក្នុងវីដេអូនេះបាទ
Thank you. pull the blanket on the ground. Okay. Just because we are married don't mean we can't sleep around. Don't tell me we stop it. So let them walk down by the river. That's it. I lay the blanket on the ground. That's it.
You mean the world to me.
So I just play up to here. As you can see, children come to the world ready to perceive sounds, right? And ready to respond to sound, ready to imitate sound. So it is very important for us educators to really treat these capacities and really try to help children develop these competencies even more, right? So come.
Chừng ở lúc xoay khởi như sao với nơi khởi nông vị tổ cứ chìa vị tổ mùa đại khởi thẳng cổ má cứ ai tật tùa bàn nơi xâm lên vì khẳng cái hơi còn ai chloi tổ bình nơi tam sản mặt hiệp bỏ quốc hơi khởi nông niêm ở lúc xoay chìa nè ọp rốn cứ trời ở bình nật tam đán nơi sản mặt hiệp nì hệ bàn chú bà lúa đầm bầy thua cam hiệp ấy đầm bầy bằng bình bằng thêm ở quốc miền sản mặt hiệp
This idea is very connected to curriculum frameworks, right? In early childhood. Here in Hong Kong, we are very familiar with the curriculum framework in Hong Kong, which has a really central ideas. I mean, some central ideas, which are, I'm going to just highlight the most important parts. The curriculum framework in Hong Kong really talks about the importance of helping children develop an inquisitive mind and an interest in learning and exploration, the ability to explore the world, to really to engage in inquiry-based learning.
Chân cầm nứt đại quát ban bằng hai như thế, cứ việc sao cho tới nâng cọp khăn này càng về thì sọc xá. Hơi nước nông Hồng Kông cứ cầm nứt ní cứ chụp ban đã cho nước nông cọp khăn này càng về thì sọc xá đại nó không chỉ nói buồn cho bấy đại kê như vậy thà mù than cơ này chỉ vật rồi bỏ họ cũng mà tối thời riêng năm pi khai thà trời miền ca sớm kê nơi không cầm đất hay ai sao cho tới chừng mỗi nâng ca chạm rom tới riêng rộng rộng chỉ vật.
So sound and the sounds that we perceive are a very interesting way to develop the curiosity of children, because we are exposed to sound through our senses. So this is a really powerful way to engage children in exploration of surroundings and nature, because sound is really everywhere. So this is another way to engage children in this exploratory learning and inquiry-based learning.
Chúng đập sao cho tới chấm môi nâng crop khăn nó cứ dùng miên cùm nong nơi nong trầy nó được cứ thả ao cùm mà nó cứ ai áp thì vọt nơi giang ba lo nơi cả thập bát được than hơi nâng sầm lên nơi chung bình bát được than nó nơi chung bình luôn bọc quạt nó nằm bay quạt nó ai hay tha chung bình luôn bọc quạt hay nông thôn mà chết hay đồng bào quạt nó ai hay tha cho rùm rồi có thưa ơi hay tha sầm lên chung bình luôn nó cứ chỉ hay tha miền ca cho rùm rồi tha ឲ្យគាត់សុបាយអញ្ចឹងណាបាទសុបាយនឹងការរករកអញ្ចឹងណាបាទ
So in other words, so sound is part of nature, right? The world, there's a lot of the world and natural phenomena is associated with sound. We human beings come to the world ready to perceive sound. So sound is a really good way, a really good tool to learn about the world. That's what I was trying to say.
Chang, một tiết cứ sầm lên cứ chia phái một nền thoa mà chia. ហើយសំឡេងហ្នឹងគឺជាគេថាវិធីសាស្ត្រក្នុងការឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងអាចរៀនសូត្រអំពីធម្មជាតិអំពីអ្វីៗនៅជុំវិញខ្លួនហើយក៏វាជាអាចជាឧបករណ៍មួយសម្រាប់នឹងការរៀនសូត្រដែរបា
ទ So this is the Hong Kong curriculum framework for early childhood. Some of you have been participating in our classes and you have seen this framework many times. So as you can see in Hong Kong, we have the Hong Kong kindergarten curriculum framework has different learning areas, as you can see in this circle.
ចឹងអលោកស្រីចូលមើលនៅក្នុង slide នេះគឺជាក្របខណ្ឌកម្មវិធីសិក្សានៃកម្មវិធីសិក្សានៅទីក្រុង Hong Kong ហើយអលោកស្រីខ្លះក៏អាចធ្លាប់ឃើញហើយដោយសារបានចូលរួមវគ្គជាមួយគាត់ច្រើនដងហើយយើងក្លែកមើលទៅឃើញថាក្របខណ្ឌនៃកម្មវិធីសាគឺយើងបែងចែកហៅថាលទ្ធផលរំពឹងទុកឬក៏អ្វីដែលផ្នែកមួយនៃដែលយើងឲ្យចង់ឲ្យកុមារចេះហ្នឹងវាមានច្រើនផ្នែកទៅតាមហៅថា learning area ហ្នឹងបាទ
Okay So as of course because I'm talking about music education music is one of the arts right so music is obviously part of the learning area of arts and creativity
អញ្ចឹងនៅពេលដែលយើងនិយាយអំពីតន្ត្រីគឺវានៅក្នុងផ្នែកមួយនៃ learning area ហ្នឹងគឺសិល្បៈហើយនឹងការបង្កើតថ្មី
But because in Hong Kong the approach is integrated so we do curriculum integration right so today I would like to share the idea that arts and creativity can be easily integrated with other areas in particular with nature and living
ចឹងនៅក្នុងក្របខណ្ឌកម្មវិធីសិក្សានៅក្នុងទីក្រុង Hong Kong ហ្នឹងគឺគេរៀនតាមរបៀប integrated approach ហ្នឹងបានជាវិធីសាស្ត្របែបចម្រុះហើយដល់លោកស្រីឃើញស្រាប់គេអាចផ្សារភ្ជាប់ទៅជាមួយនឹងធម្មជាតិនិងការរស់នៅបាទតែមានជាផ្នែកមួយនៃការសិក្សាដែរ
So through sound through exploring sound creating with sound exploring comparing analyzing the sound of the world we can allow children to integrate arts and nature or science
ចឹងនៅក្នុងសកម្មភាពនៃការឲ្យកុមាររករកសំឡេងឬបង្កើតសំឡេងអីផ្សេងផ្សេងឬក៏សកម្មភាពដែលផ្សារភ្ជាប់ជាមួយនឹងសំឡេងឬក៏តន្ត្រីហ្នឹងគឺយើងអាចអនុញ្ញាតឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងផ្សារភ្ជាប់គ្នារវាងផ្នែកនៃការសិក្សាឬក៏ learning area ហ្នឹងពីរចូលគ្នាបានគឺសិល្បៈហើយនឹងធម្មជាតិនឹងការរស់នៅបាទ
So again, music in preschool is much more than singing, playing instruments. We can do many other activities with our children that also involve sound, exploring about sound, creating with sound. It doesn't need to be the sound of a musical instrument. It can be the sounds of nature.
ដល់ត្រីនឹងចម្រៀងនៅមតីសាគឺយើងមិនត្រឹមតែឲ្យកុមាររាំហើយនឹងច្រៀងឬក៏គឺវាជាសកម្មភាពដែលអាចឲ្យកុមារនឹងគឺរកសំឡេងនៅក្នុងនឹងអាចឲ្យកុមារនឹងគឺបង្កើតនូវសំឡេងដោយខ្លួនឯង
So now I would like to invite all of you to just look at these pictures and then try to imagine in your head the sound of these pictures. If you are here, what sound would you hear? Just close your eyes for 2 seconds and try to imagine the sound of this beach. So come.
ងគាត់សូមឲ្យលោកស្រីអាចពិនិត្យមើលទៅលើរូបភាពនេះហើយបិទភ្នែកតិចទៅហើយសម័យមើលថាតើសំឡេងអ្វីដែលអាចមាននៅក្នុងរូបភាពនេះបាទ
Try to imagine the sound of a beach and also try to imagine what does it tell you? What do you feel when you imagine that sound? What expressiveness does it have? What does it tell you? What is what you think about when you imagine the sound of this peaceful beach.
ចឹងគាត់សូមឲ្យលោកស្រីអាចបិទភ្នែកទៅហើយសូមឲ្យជួយធ្វើការសមាសម័យថាវាមានសម្លេងអីដែលកើតចេញឡើងអំពីរូបភាពទាំងអស់រូបភាពមួយនេះបាទ
So imagine now these two birds. How does it sound? How do you think they would sound? And what does it tell you? What does it transmit? What kind of emotion it gives if you think about the sound of these two little birds?
ចឹងគាត់ឲ្យលោកស្រីមើលទៅរូបភាពដែលមានបាក់សៃទាំងពីរនេះទៀតហើយលោកស្រីអាចសមាសម័យថាមានសម្លេងអីខ្លះដែលចែកតែចេញអំពីរូបភាពដែលចេញអំពីបាក់សៃទាំងពីរនេះបាទ
How about this the sound of a city, right? This is Hong Kong, right? So if you imagine the sound of a city, what does it remind you? What feelings, what emotions do you perceive when you hear a big city and how the big city sounds to you?
ចឹងរូបមួយទៀតនេះគឺជារូបទីក្រុងហុងកុងដែលមានបើសមានបើសអាទេភ្លើងអញ្ចឹងទៅហើយលោកស្រីអាចសម័យមើលថាតើមានសម្លេងអ្វីខ្លះដែលចេញអំពីទីក្រុងដែលមានភាពគេថាមានញឹកនេះបាទ
How about the sound of rain in a forest or how about the sound of like a festival like this festival in Hong Kong what kind of feeling what kind of emotions do you get with rain or with a festival
ចឹងរូបបន្តទៀតនេះគឺជារូបភាពភ្លៀងតើមានសម្លេងអ្វីខ្លះដែលមានដែលចេញពីទឹកភ្លៀងហ្នឹងហើយមួយទៀតគឺរូបភាពការប្រពៃពិធីបុណ្យចូលឆ្នាំនៅក្នុងទីក្រុងហុងកុងហ្នឹងតើវាមានសម្លេងអីខ្លះដែរបាទចឹងឲ្យលោកស្រីអាចសម័យតិចមកបាទ
And then finally how about if you think of the steps like someone walking at a park like can you imagine how that sounds and what kind of emotions and what kind of feelings do you perceive when you imagine that sound and how about these babies crying when you imagine that sound how do you feel like what emotions does it give you so come
ហើយរូបភាពបន្តទៀតហ្នឹងគឺជារូបភាពកុមារអ្នកដើរហាត់កីឡានៅក្នុងសួនអញ្ចឹងណាហើយនៅពេលដែលគាត់ដើរឬឃើញរូបភាពដើរអញ្ចឹងយើងអាចសម័យដល់សម្លេងនៃការដើររបស់គាត់ហ្នឹងមិនដែរហើយមួយទៀតគឺជារូបភាពកូនង៉ែតកំពុងតែយំអញ្ចឹងលោកស្រីអាចសម័យថាសម្លេងកូនង៉ែតយំហ្នឹងមានគេថាសម្លេងរបៀបបិចមក
So all of us are able to imagine the sound of all of these pictures. All of us are able to imagine how we would feel if we can listen to all of these images, all of these pictures, and all of us are able to explain the sound of how these things would sound, and also we would be able to really feel some emotions, feel some feelings, and this situation would communicate something to us. So we come to the world and we are experts in feeling and responding to all of these different sounds.
ចឹងអលោស្រីអាចសម័យទៅក្នុងរូបភាពទាំងអស់នេះទៅហើយលោកស្រីអាចសម័យហើយតើរូបភាពនីមួយមួយនេះវាមានសម្លេងអីខ្លះហើយនៅពេលដែលចេញសម្លេងហ្នឹងតើលោកស្រីអាចមានអារម្មណ៍ឬក៏អាចបញ្ចេញអារម្មណ៍អីខ្លះទៅលើរូបភាពទាំងអស់ហ្នឹងហើយរូបនៅពេលដែលយើងបញ្ចេញអារម្មណ៍ហើយថារូបភាពមួយណាវាអាចគេថាធ្វើឲ្យយើងហ្នឹងមានអារម្មណ៍ល្អឬក៏អាចមានអារម្មណ៍មិនល្អអញ្ចឹងណាអាចធ្វើការតំណាក់តំណងគ្នារវាងរូបភាពហ្នឹងជាមួយនឹងលោកស្រីទៅបាទ
One of the main important ideas of this talk that I want to share with you today is that the sounds of the world is the basic for musical creativity, right? When we as teachers design activities that involve sound perception of sound, exploration of sound, and also creation activities, these have enormous potential for inquiry-based learning. We can design activities that in which children can create using the sounds of the world.
ច
chúng mù than cứ nơi ca bằng hai nơi bên đấy cứ trong ở lô xây đằng thà sầm lê rồi có sầm lê nơi không đi nơi không phổ lộ nó cứ vì chỉ mù than cứ nơi ca bằng cao nơi đầm trấy hơi cọt bị chạm bật than thiết thà nơi bên đấy dương do sầm lê nơi không bật than nông mù than nó ai bật cao chia sẻ cam phết để ao cụ mà nó ai bật cao chia đòn tray được ai rock rock sầm lê như luôn ai nhé nên cứ chỉ bật hết mỗi này inquiry based learning nương ai và
so children are able to discover the possibilities and expressive qualities of the world around them. If you show your children in your classrooms these pictures, children in your classrooms will be able to imagine how these pictures sound. They are able to feel some emotions when you show them these pictures, and they are able to create. They would be able to create some original creations based on these sounds.
ថា បង្ហាញ នៅ គុណភាព បង្ហាញ នៅ សម្លេង មក វិញ ដូច ជា original អញ្ចឹង ណា អញ្ចឹង ដូច ជា អស់ លោក ស្រី ឃើញ រូបភាព ទាំង អស់ អំបញ្ញ មិញ ហ្នឹង គឺ នៅ ពេល ដែល យើង បង្ហាញ រូបភាព ហ្នឹង ទៅ កុមារ កុមារ នឹង អាច គេ ហៅ ថា បង្ហាញ នៅ សម្លេង original ហ្នឹង មក ឲ្យ យើង ប្រាប់ មក គ្រូ វិញ ហើយ ក៏ គាត់ អាច បង្ហាញ នៅ អារម្មណ៍ ថា នៅ ពេល ដែល ឃើញ លឺ សម្លេង បែប ហ្នឹង ទៅ គាត់ មាន អារម្មណ៍ បែប មិន And then God adds behind you moving to time, reject and time at all.
So there are many books in the field of musical creativity, like these ones, that really propose pedagogical strategies aligned with this view of creativity. Musical creativity is not only singing songs and playing instruments. Musical creativity really involves active creation with sound, any kind of sound.
Chúng ni គឺ ជា សភៅ មួយ ចំនួន ដែល ផ្សារ ភ្ជាប់ ជាមួយ នឹង យុទ្ធ សាស្ត្រ ឬ ក៏ គរុក សល ដែល ផ្សារ ភ្ជាប់ ទៅ ជាមួយ នឹង ការ គេ ហៅ ថា បង្រៀន តន្ត្រី នៅ ក្នុង កម្រិត អាយុ កុមារ តូច ហើយ គាត់ ចង់ បញ្ជាក់ ឡើង វិញ ថា ការ បង្រៀន តន្ត្រី នៅ ក្នុង កម្រិត កុមារ តូច ហ្នឹង មិន មែន តែ គាត់ ថា ច្រៀង ហើយ នឹង រាំ នឹង ការ លេង តន្ត្រី ទេ គឺ ជា ការ បង្កើត នៅ សម្លេង បង្កើត នៅ គេ ហៅ ថា រុក រោក នៅ សម្លេង ឯ ផ្សេង ផ្សេង នៅ ក្នុង កម្រិត កុមារ តូច នៅ ក្នុង បរិស្ថាន ហ្នឹង គឺ វា ជា ចំណុច សំខាន់ ណាស់ ដែល ជា មូល ដ្ឋាន គឺ ក្នុង ការ បង្កើត តន្ត្រី បាទ
So there are many resources that teachers in preschools can use to work with our preschool children related to sound, right? So if you click on this link, you will go online and you will find all kinds of sounds that you can explore with your children in the classroom. Rain in the city, beaches, all kinds of things, cameras, all kinds of sound that you can really use in class to train teachers to train your children in terms of perceiving sound, describing what they hear, and putting it in words, and trying to really communicate their perceptions with their words.
Chúng lo sợi khởi nên trong slide này cứ chia thay thà thôn thiên rồi có phổ ai cả sao một chút nuối đại sao chụp cho mùi nâng thay thà ở lo sợi ai do từ bờ dân cụ mà tối vì ໂດຍໄສອາດ ຄລິກ ໃນក្នុង ລິງ ໂດຍໄດ້ອາດເຄີຍຖ້າສໍາເລງພຽງລະບຽບແມກສໍາເລງສະຫມົດລະບຽບແມກສໍາເລງກາມາຣາໃນក្នុងການຖອດພາບຍົນໃນລະບຽບແມກຈັ່ງໂດຍໄສອາດຍົກເຮົາຫາຖ້າທຸນທຽນສໍາເລງຕ່າງອັນນີ້ອາດເຈົ້າໄດ້ឲ្យກຸມາສດັບໂຕໃຫ້ອາດឲ្យគេຕຽຫຼືກໍອາດឲ្យគេຮົກຮົກສະກໍາພາບໃສໆໃນក្នុងຖະນະຮຽນບາດຈັ່ງອາດຮຽບຈໍາຈະສະກໍາພາບໃສໆໃນក្នុងຖະນະຮຽນບາດ
This view of creativity in music is very aligned with the curriculum framework in Hong Kong. Again, the curriculum in Hong Kong talks about the importance of expressing feelings. So you can see here, expressing feelings, create with different senses, being able to express their thoughts, their feelings. So these ideas appear very often in the curriculum framework. and also create and express, right? So what I am going to share from now on is activities that can be used to foster musical creativity in our classrooms with children.
Slide នេះម្ដងទៀតគឺបញ្ជាក់អំពីតន្ត្រីគឺផ្សារភ្ជាប់ទៅជាមួយនឹងក្របខ័ណ្ឌកម្មវិធីសិក្សានៅក្នុងមតិសិក្សានៅទីក្រុងហុងកុងដែលដោតទៅលើ learning area ដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងសិល្បៈហើយនឹងការបង្កើតថ្មីហើយគោលនងគឺចង់ឲ្យកុមារនឹងអាចថាបង្ហាញនៅអារម្មណ៍របស់គាត់ហើយអាចបង្កើតឬក៏បង្ហាញនៅគេហៅថាអារម្មណ៍ដែលផ្សារភ្ជាប់នឹងតន្ត្រីហ្នឹងហើយនឹងអាចឲ្យគាត់ហ្នឹងបង្ហាញនៅគំនិតឬក៏អារម្មណ៍ហ្នឹងសម្រាប់ការបង្កើតថ្មីហើយនឹងអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងដឹងអំពីចង្វាក់ឬបង្កើតការបង្កើតចង្វាក់ឬក៏ការបង្កើតនៅសកម្មភាពមួយចំនួនដែលផ្សារភ្ជាប់ជាមួយនឹងសំឡេងហើយនឹងតន្ត្រីហ្នឹងតែម្ដងបាទ
Let me share with you some activities that you could do with toddlers. Toddlers are around 2 to 3 years old, right? So when we are working with those little ones, when they are 2 to 3, toddlers can really listen to children at that age, can identify songs, they can compare songs, and they can also imitate familiar songs in their environment. They can really do all of those things.
អញ្ចឹងនេះគឺជាគោលបំណងឬក៏ជាគេថាការផ្សារភ្ជាប់គោលបំណងក្នុងការបង្រៀនកុមារតូចនៅក្នុងកម្រិតអាយុ2ទៅ3ឆ្នាំហើយយើងមានគោលបំណងថាកុមារនឹងអាចស្ដាប់ហើយនឹងអាចបែងចែកចម្រៀងតាមប្រភេទចម្រៀងហើយអាចប្រៀបធៀបចម្រៀងមួយទៅចម្រៀងមួយហើយនឹងអាចគេហៅថាធ្វើចំណាត់ថ្នាក់ឬក៏បែងចែកសំឡេងណាដែលដូចដូចគ្នានៅក្នុងបរិស្ថាននៅក្នុងអវ័យដែលជុំវិញគាត់ហ្នឹងបា
ទ So we can do activities in our class and we can do activities with these little ones about listening, identifying, comparing, imitating, for example, natural phenomena. Imagine that you find the sound of rain, ocean, sun, thunderstorms. And then you ask children to identify what is this sound? What is this exactly? Teachers can really have conversations. How do you know that it is an ocean? How do you know that this is a thunderstorm? So these kind of activities exercise the perception skills of children, and children are able to express with the words what they hear.
ព័ន្ធនឹងការថាកតាធម្មជាតិនេះគឺលោកស្រីនឹងអាចយកសំឡេងភ្លៀងធ្លាក់ឬក៏សំឡេងសមុទ្រឬក៏សំឡេងខ្យល់ព្យុះអីហ្នឹងអាចយកមកឲ្យកុមារស្ដាប់ដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់ហ្នឹងហ្វឹកហាត់នៃការហ្វឹកហាត់តិចឬក៏ហ្វឹកហាត់ការស្ដាប់របស់គាត់ហ្នឹងទៅក្នុងគេហៅថាហេតការរបស់ធម្មជាតិហ្នឹងដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់អាចដឹងអំពីបរិស្ថានជុំវិញគាត់ថាអូចិត្តខ្យល់ព្យុះឬក៏ចិត្តភ្លៀងធ្លាក់ឬក៏គាត់កំពុងនៅសមុទ្រអីចឹងនេះគឺជាបទពិសោធន៍មួយដែលអ្នកអប់រំគួរតែបង្កើតដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់ហ្នឹងហ្វឹកហាត់ការស្ដាប់ហ្វឹកហាត់តិចគាត់
Okay. Children can also compare like the sound of different transportations, for example, a car, a bus, trains, a bicycle. Do you think you can do activities for children to listen to different transportations or machines and then identify what it is? These activities are important because children have to think, they have to identify, they have to put it in words. So basically what children are doing is really thinking about sound and making sound an object of inquiry.
ចឹងពាក់ព័ន្ធមួយទៀតគឺពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងម៉ាស៊ីនហើយអូឡូស្រីអាចរៀបចំសកម្មភាពអាចឲ្យកុមារបងវឹកឬក៏អាចបែងចែកសំឡេងការស្ដាប់រវាងម៉ាស៊ីនឡានម៉ាស៊ីន bus ម៉ាស៊ីនរថភ្លើងឬក៏ម៉ាស៊ីនម៉ូតូម៉ាស៊ីនឬក៏កង់អីចឹងទៅស្ដាប់នៅគ្រឿងម៉ាស៊ីនអស់ហ្នឹងហើយគេអាចបែងចែកធ្វើចំណុចទី2សកម្មភាពទី2ដែលបង្កើតឡើងដើម្បីបង្វឹកនៃការស្ដាប់ដូចគ្នាដែរបា
ទ We can do exactly the same thing for human noise like male female babies crying the sound of our bodies, also for animals, children can be comparing how a cat sound and dogs and birds and lions and all kinds of animals you can imagine, right? So you can do many activities that involve listening, identifying, comparing, imitating. And when we work with sound, we are doing and making music, really. So this is also part of music.
Some lame no sray, the lame of my jump, the lame of my sour, same saying, done by our cotton at by giant and at creep tip near of being some lame jung or the beer bomb. I look near that, which is not chunk rock, that one a sat looks straight at rip chunks can keep us up some lame chmas and lame sky, some lame bassail, some lame class, some lame tau, same saying, done by a cotton, I book hat, nine more nights and lame. Bạn chạy xâm lên, đăng thang xâm lên và phết sạch này, phết sạch nó hay là ai bịp thiệp như thả sạch ná, đôi sạch này chúng ta mấy cư chìa này mỗi này ca bằng riêng đầm trái nông công bạch mặt tay này.
Very good. Let me, well, here you have a few other websites that I would like to recommend where you can find different kinds of sounds. If you have an internet connection in your classroom and a computer, you can use your computer to play some of these sounds, and then having your children in class identifying and guessing what they are hearing, and also justifying with their own words why they think this is a sound, right? So you can use a computer and technology to really engage children in these kinds of activities. So here you find many websites with free sound effects that you could use in your classroom for activities.
Chúng dùng miền website cho trán để đào từ lớp sau này phật nữa hay là sai ai sai áp chụp ai copy website nâng tốt tới đồng bày ai cam ពីបងរៀនឲ្យកុមារឬក៏អាចយកសម្លេងហ្នឹងសម្លេងឲ្យវៃនៅពេលដែលគាត់ទាយដឹងថាសម្លេងហ្នឹងសម្លេងជាបញ្ចសត្វអីឬក៏សម្លេងអ្វីហ្នឹងគាត់អាចបង្កើតជាពាក្យឬក៏បង្កើតជាការសន្ទនាមកយើងវិញអញ្ចឹងហើយគឺជាផ្នែកមួយនៃការអភិវឌ្ឍផ្នែកភាសាថែមដែរហើយអស់លោកស្រីអាចយកវេបសាយទាំងអស់នេះទៅដើម្បី
very good. So these websites are really, really helpful. So some activities that you can do with children at that age, you can ask them, close your eyes until you see this sound in your head. Or you can do the game of you need to guess what the sound is, and you can play different sounds, and then children have to guess, and then they have to say what they think it is. Also, they can imitate their sound with their voices. Just you can play any of these sounds here, and then you can ask children to imitate with their voices, or also they can imitate where their bodies. You can really do many things.
Can also say your website tới đồng bày và cả chia sẻ cam học hiếm đôi chia ao cũng mà bật nghe cho hơi ai ao cũng mà đập sầm lên rồi bỏ sau này phật tới rồi có ao cũng mà nó ai nơi sầm lên sau này phật nữa tổ mật thiết cứ ai ao cũng mà nó phơi trap tam sầm lên sau này phật nhớ rồi có ai cho của mà nâng cái hai thà phơi cài với cả bà tới tam luôn bà tới tam sập lên nhưng bà ok.
And also finally you can ask children to respond to the sound with their bodies and with free movement. If you play two sounds that are really very different, for example the transportation, for example the sound of a truck and the sound of a bicycle, and then asking children to imitate with their bodies how a bicycle sounds and how a truck sounds. So this will involve a lot of creative work. Children will have to reproduce, imitate with their bodies, something that they perceive. So these really create connections and they really foster their expression and creativity.
ឯចំណុចចុងក្រោយហ្នឹងគឺអាចឲ្យលោកស្រីអាចរៀបចំចេតកម្មភាពថាដាក់សម្លេងពីរទៅដូចឧទាហរណ៍ថាសម្លេងត្រាក់ឬក៏សម្លេងកង់ហើយនៅពេលដែលឲ្យកុមារស្ដាប់ទៅគឺឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងធ្វើចលនាឬក៏ធ្វើត្រាប់តាមសម្លេងទាំងពីរហ្នឹងតែម្ដងដើម្បីឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងអាចគេថាបង្ហាញនៅសកម្មភាពឬក៏បង្ហាញនៅការឆ្លើយតបរបស់គេវិញនៅពេលដែលគេស្ដាប់នៅសម្លេង sound effect ហ្នឹងបាទ
Let's watch this video of this kindergarten teacher who is doing something very similar with these children who are toddlers. They must be around 2 to 3 years of age.
ចឹងនឹងវីដេអូនេះគឺជាវីដេអូដែលបង្ហាញអំពីសកម្មភាពអ្នកគ្រូនៅក្នុងថ្នាក់មួយហើយកុមារនេះគឺនៅក្នុងកម្រិតអាយុ2ទៅ3ឆ្នាំទេបាទមិនទាន់ចូលក្មេងមត្តេយ្យនៅឡើយទេបា
ទ So let's see how the teacher is engaging children in responding to the sound with their bodies.
ចឹងលោកស្រីអាចមើលសកម្មភាពថាតើលោកគ្រូអ្នកគ្រូគាត់ធ្វើសកម្មភាពលើកទឹកចិត្តកុមារឲ្យខ្លះដើម្បីឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងធ្វើការចូលរួមនៅឆ្លើយតបនៅសម្លេងដែលគាត់បាននៅសកម្មភាពដែលគាត់បានរៀបចំនេះបាទ
Good RC then come on run
just hi come on skate
go skate
So as you can see, children, the teacher is doing an activity, which is very simple. The teacher has some music. And the only thing that the teacher is asking children to do is to respond with their bodies to the sound they hear. Sometimes it's fast, sometimes it's quiet, sometimes it's slow. So the teacher is asking children to just listen to it and then respond with their bodies.
អញ្ចឹងលោកស្រីឃើញក្នុងវីដេអូគឺជាសកម្មភាពអ្នកគ្រូនិងកុមារតូចក្នុងថ្នាក់ដែលគាត់បានចាក់សម្លេងតន្ត្រីហើយសម្លេងហ្នឹងគឺមានពេលខ្លះគឺវាឲ្យអាចឲ្យកុមារធ្វើសកម្មភាពលឿនហើយសម្លេងខ្លះគឺឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងស្ងាត់ហើយសម្លេងខ្លះឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងធ្វើសកម្មភាពយឺតៗហើយគ្រូគាត់ថាប្រាប់ឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងធ្វើតាមហើយយើងឃើញថាសកម្មភាពគឺពេលខ្លះអ្នកគ្រូគាត់រត់ទៅឲ្យកុមារធ្វើតាមចឹងទៅហើយពេលខ្លះឲ្យស្ងាត់ចឹងទៅគឺមានសលេងស្ងាត់ចឹងទៅអានេះគឺជាសកម្មភាពមួយដែលយើងអាចបង្កើតជាសកម្មភាពរៀនតន្ត្រីនៅក្នុងកម្រិត toddler បាទកម្រិត2ទៅ3ឆ្នាំបា
ទ So there's another video that I share here later I will share the slides with you I don't know why the videos didn't workBut later I will share the presentation slides with everybody and you can watch the videos fully.
គាត់មានបទបង្ហាញមួយទៀតប៉ុន្តែដោយសារប្រហែលជាចាក់អត់ចេញអញ្ចឹងគាត់នឹងផ្ញើបទបង្ហាញទាំងជារួមទាំងឲ្យគ្នាយើងទាំងអស់គ្នាដើម្បីចែករំលែកហើយលោកស្រីនឹងអាចមើលវីដេអូនឹងពេញតែម្ដងបាទ
This is another video with more activities related to the activities that I just described.
នេះគឺជាវីដេអូដែលមានពាក់ព័ន្ធជាមួយនឹងសកម្មភាពដែលគាត់បានបញ្យលហើយបាទ
All right so when children are already a little bit older primary 1 primary 2 so 3 to 5 years of age approximately we can start doing a little bit more sophisticated activities
នេះគឺជាសកម្មភាពសម្រាប់កុមារតូចដែលនៅក្នុងអាយុ3ទៅ5ឆ្នាំនៅសុកគេហៅ K1 K2 ហ្នឹងហើយសកម្មភាពដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងតន្ត្រីហ្នឹងគឺវាអាចមានកម្រិតរៀងលំបាកជាង2ទៅ3ឆ្នាំមុនមិញអញ្ចឹងតិចដែរបា
ទ So because children now start to develop their language and is their language is more and more sophisticated they would be able to describe they would be able to classify compare sound they would be able to do a lot more things describe classify compare analyze imitate and also create with different kinds of sound in the environment so they would be able to do a lot more things
ពីព្រោះថាកុមារនៅក្នុងកម្រិតអាយុ3ទៅ5ឆ្នាំនេះគឺគេអាចបញ្ចូលគឺអាចបែងចែកអាចប្រៀបធៀបអាចវិភាគនិងអាចធ្វើត្រាប់តាមឬក៏អាចបង្កើតថ្មីនៅអ្វីដែលនៅក្នុងជុំវិញបឋានបង្កើតនឹងជាសម្លេងផ្សេងផ្សេងនៅក្នុងជុំវិញបឋានរបស់គេបាទ
For example we could do an activity that we ask the children close your eyes and you need to imagine how the sound of birds sound in your head we ask the children simply to close their eyes and imagine how the sound
ចឹងក៏លើឧទាហរណ៍ជាសកម្មភាពទី1គឺសូមឲ្យកុមារគាត់បិទភ្នែកគាត់ទៅហើយគាត់អ្នកគ្រូនឹងអាចឲ្យកុមារនឹងធ្វើការសមាសម័យថាសំឡេងបាក់សៃមានសំឡេងរបៀបម៉េចហើយនឹងសំឡេងបាក់សៃនឹងអាចបង្កើតជាការចងចាំនៅក្នុងកំណត់ខួរក្បាលរបស់គេបា
ទ And then we can ask children to describe with their words how they sound tell me how does it sound what are the vocabulary they use to describe
ហើយបន្តមកគឺអ្នកគ្រូអាចសួរទៅកុមារថាតើសំឡេងបាក់សៃហ្នឹងមានសំឡេងវាបែបចឹងអាចឲ្យគេបញ្យលឬក៏អាចឲ្យគេនេះចឹងគេអាចបង្កើតជាពាក្យឬក៏អាចបង្កើតជា clear ប្រយោគអីដើម្បីបញ្យលយើងវិញបានបា
ទ Then for example we can also ask children give children tables like this and do classification activities for example imagine that we give them a table like this human sounds animal sounds and then natural sounds and machines so we ask children to classify the sounds we give them sounds we play sounds in class and we simply ask them to put it in the right column if this is a man talking it would go under human if it is a cat or a dog or a crocodile it will go here so they will be listening to some input and they simply need to classify in the right place so that is a classification activity of sound that really trains the perception of children
ហើយចំណុចមួយទៀតគឺជាចំណុចនៃការធ្វើការបែងចែកចំណាត់ថ្នាក់ធ្វើចំណាត់ថ្នាក់នៃសំឡេងគឺវាអាចមានជាសំឡេងមនុស្សសំឡេងសត្វសំឡេងធម្មជាតិហើយគេសំឡេងម៉ាស៊ីនលោកស្រីអាចចាក់សំឡេងនៅក្នុងថ្នាក់ទៅដើម្បីឲ្យគេនឹងអាចយកកាតឬក៏យកអីដើម្បីឲ្យគេ classify ថាសំឡេងនេះជាសំឡេងមនុស្សសំឡេងនេះសំឡេងសត្វឆ្មាសត្វឆ្កាសត្វអីផ្សេងផ្សេងអញ្ចឹងដើម្បីយកមកដាក់នៅក្នុងតារាងនេះនេះគឺសកម្មភាពមួយទៀតដែរដែលឲ្យកុមារនឹងមានបំណិននៃការបែងចែកសំឡេងបានច្បាស់លាស់ដែរបាទ
Some of you may say but is this music because this doesn't sound like music this sounds like and I would say yes of course it is this is part of music because music is all about sound about thinking about sound and comparing sound classifying sound so it may not sound very much to music but it is really is music and it should be part of music education
អញ្ចឹងសំឡេងទាំងអស់នេះហើយគឺជាផ្នែកមួយនៃតន្ត្រីហើយលោកស្រីគាត់ថាតន្ត្រីវាមិនអាចថាចេញពីតែឧបករណ៍តន្ត្រីទេគឺជួយអាចចេញអំពីសំឡេងក្នុងធម្មជាតិនឹងសំឡេងមនុស្សសំឡេងសត្វសំឡេងម៉ាស៊ីនឬក៏សំឡេងនេះក៏អាចយកមកធ្វើជាបង្កើតទៅជាតន្ត្រីដែរនេះហើយគឺជាការបង្រៀនតន្ត្រីនៅក្នុងការអប់រំកុមារតូចបា
ទ We can also do activities like this one activities that involve comparison right So imagine that we give children this table and they need to compare sounds that are very high, sounds that are low, and then sounds that are in between. And they have to compare based on this, right? So they would be saying, okay, sounds that are very high, probably the birds. Sound that are low, definitely the truck, and in between the bell. So they have to imagine how these things sound, and they have to compare. That's because it's a comparison activity, and then they have to classify the characteristics of those sound. This is all music education. This is, we are comparing the characteristics of sound.
តារាងមួយទៀតនេះគឺជាតារាងដែលប្រៀបធៀបសំឡេងខ្លាំងខ្សោយឬក៏សំឡេងលម្អអញ្ចឹងអញ្ចឹងលោកស្រីអាចឃើញថារូបភាព track ហ្នឹងយើងអាចឲ្យកុមារទាយទៅថាសំឡេង track ហ្នឹងវាសំឡេងឮខ្លាំងឬខ្សោយសំឡេងបាក់សៃឬខ្លាំងឬខ្សោយឬក៏សំឡេងកណ្ដឹងហ្នឹងវាខ្លាំងខ្សោយអញ្ចឹងគេអាចធ្វើការសមាសម័យថាគិតទៅដល់សំឡេងហ្នឹងហើយគេអាចជ្រើសរើសយកកម្រិតនៃសម្លេងណាមួយនៃប្រភេទសម្លេងហ្នឹងហើយនេះហើយគឺជាការបង្រៀនតន្ត្រីនៅកម្រិតកុមារតូចនេះហើយបាទ
We can also give children this table empty and we can go to ask them outside go outside and then found sounds that are high that are low and that are in between go outside explore the backyard of the kindergarten and find sounds that are highlow and in between so children can play a more active role finding those sounds themselves
hey ចំណុចមួយទៀតលោកស្រីអាចឲ្យកុមារបានថាលុបរូបភាពនៅខាងប្រភេទសំឡេងហ្នឹងចេញទៅអាចឲ្យកុមារចេញទៅក្រៅហ្នឹងដើម្បីរកសំឡេងថាតើសំឡេងនៅក្នុងបរិស្ថាននៅក្នុងធម្មជាតិជុំវិញខ្លួនរបស់គេហ្នឹងតើសំឡេងមួយណាវាមានកម្រិតខ្លាំងកម្រិតខ្សោយឬក៏កម្រិតមធ្យមនេះហើយគឺជាសមត្ថភាពដែលអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងរករកស្វែងរកសម្លេងនៅក្នុងធម្មជាតិរបស់ពួកគេហ្នឹងហើយជាផ្នែកមួយនៃការបង្រៀនតន្ត្រីឬក៏បង្រៀនថាមុខវិជ្ជាតន្ត្រីហ្នឹងនៅកម្រិតកុមារតូចដែរបា
ទ And finally also children can imitate their sound not only comparing the sound but they can imitate what they hearFor example, with their bodies, with other objects, they can identify objects to imitate other sounds. Or of course, they can use, if you have musical instruments in your classrooms, they can also use musical instruments. But when we do this kind of work, children need to be very creative. Imagine that you ask children to imitate a truck with objects. So how do they find...the connection, how do they imitate a track with objects in the classroom? Or how do they imitate birds with their own bodies? So they have to do a lot of exploration, they have to do a lot of experimentation. So this involves creativity.
ចំណុចមួយទៀតគឺអលោកស្រីអាចឲ្យកុមារធ្វើត្រាប់តាមសំឡេងសត្វហ្នឹងដោយប្រើរាងកាយឬក៏ដោយប្រើរបស់របរអីផ្សេងៗដែលនៅជុំវិញខ្លួនហ្នឹងប៉ុន្តែលោកស្រីអាចគិតថានៅពេលដែលកុមារអាចឲ្យកុមារធ្វើសកម្មភាពនេះគឺកុមារហ្នឹងវានៅក្នុងគេថាកម្រិតនៃការចងចាំកម្រិតនៃការគេថាស្គាល់សម្លេងនឹងច្បាស់ស្គាល់វត្ថុនឹងច្បាស់ហើយអញ្ចឹងនៅពេលដែលកុមារអាចធ្វើបានហ្នឹងគឺវាអាចបង្កើននៅជំនាញបន្ថែមមួយទៀតគឺជាជំនាញបង្កើតថ្មីនៅក្នុងការបង្រៀនតន្ត្រីនេះតែម្ដងបាទ
Very good. And then finally when children are a little bit older, when children are in preschool in the third year of preschools, so we can do similar activities but more complex activities that also are similar to the ones before but also involve composition and creation.
អញ្ចឹងលោកស្រីអាចបង្រៀនបាននៅក្នុងកម្រិតកុមារអាយុ3ឆ្នាំទៅ5ឆ្នាំនេះគឺមានសកម្មភាពដូចគ្នាជាមួយនឹងកុមារ K1 K2 នឹងដែរប៉ុន្តែលោកស្រីនឹងអាចរៀបចំសកម្មភាពហ្នឹងឲ្យវាមានភាពស្មុគស្មាញខ្លាំងជាងអ្វីដែលគាត់បញ្យល់មិញហ្នឹងគឺដើម្បីឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងអាចធ្វើការគេហៅថាចូលរួមក្នុងការបកកើតឬក៏ការបកកើតថ្មីហ្នឹងបានកាន់តែល្អប្រសើរបាទ
again we can first children can just describe sounds the sounds that they perceive. Of course, because children now are older, they will be able to use more precise words to describe what they hear. So first is a description activity of sounds they can just describe.
ចឹងបសកម្មភាពវិញគឺយើងអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងធ្វើការបញ្ចូលនៅសំឡេងហើយនឹងអាចបង្កើតនៅគេថាភាពសង្កត់ធ្ងន់នៅគេហៅថាជញ្ជីអ្នកឬក៏ពាក្យផ្សេងផ្សេងហ្នឹងឲ្យបានកាន់តែច្បាស់ជាងមុនបាទ
Then they can also, children at this stage, they can also explain the differences between sounds. So imagine that you show them a truck and you show them a car, and then you ask them to explain the differences, and they have to explain in words the differences. So they have to really do a lot of exercise in terms of explaining how to differ. That's complex, that's sophisticated. So that's a very good thing in terms of putting into words their perceptions. So explain the differences and that activity we can do.
ចំណុចទី2គឺពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងការបញ្ចូលនៅប្រភេទសំឡេងខុសគ្នាដូចឧទាហរណ៍អំបញ្ញមិញអញ្ចឹងគឺគាត់ឲ្យសំឡេងឡានត្រាក់មួយនិងសំឡេងឡានធម្មតាមួយហើយនឹងយើងអាចបង្កើតជាសកម្មភាពឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងបញ្ចូលវិញថាតើសំឡេងត្រាក់ឬសំឡេងឡានធម្មតាហ្នឹងវាខុសគ្នាដូចម្ដេចនេះហើយគឺជាការបង្កើតនៅសកម្មភាពនៃការបង្រៀនតន្ត្រីនៅកម្រិតកុមារតូចតា
You could also do activities asking children how would this sound in another area, right? Things don't sound the same inside or outside, for example. They can really experiment how different objects sound differently indoors and outdoors.
ហើយអលោកស្រីអាចរៀបចំសកម្មភាពថាសំឡេងឲ្យរករកសំឡេងនៅក្នុងថ្នាក់ហើយរករកសំឡេងនៅក្រៅថ្នាក់តើវាមានភាពខុសគ្នារបៀបម៉េចបា
ទ How this would sound in different times of the year, for example winter and summer. That's another activity, and also very importantly we can ask children to represent and compose musical pieces to represent something that they have in mind, to represent the expressive qualities of something they have in mind with a graphic score.
ចំណុចមួយទៀតគឺពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងសលេងដែលមានខុសគ្នារវាងរដូវសញ្ញានិងរដូវក្តៅឯផ្សេងផ្សេងអញ្ចឹងហើយមួយទៀតគឺអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងគឺគេថា compose បណ្ណារៀបសរសេរជាសលេងតន្ត្រីហ្នឹងនៅក្នុង graphic មួយបាទ graphic score មួយបាទ
So also for example you can read children a poem or you can read them a storybook in literacy class and you can read them a book and then you could ask them to compose a soundtrack with the sound of the story so you ask them to investigate how we can really tell the story with sound and they can really compose
ហើយមួយទៀតនៅពេលដែលលោកស្រីអាចបង្កើតចិត្តសកម្មភាពអានឬនិទានឬក៏អានជាកំណាព្យហើយយើងអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងបង្កើតទៅជាសំឡេងបានន័យថា soundtrack ហ្នឹងដែលធ្វើថាតាមសំឡេងកំណាព្យនិងសំឡេងឬនិទានហ្នឹងបាទ
So children don't need to be musicians or finally they need to produceand record a performance. So it is very important that in the end, children produce something that they are able to show and record, for example, with a phone or take pictures or with a recording. But children don't need to be
នៅពេលដែលចំណុចមួយទៀតគឺពេលដែលយើងឲ្យកុមារអាចសរសេរជាបទចម្រៀងនិពន្ធនឹងហើយគឺនិពន្ធបទភ្លេងនឹងហើយគឺនឹងអាចឲ្យគេ record បានថាថតទុកនៅអ្វីដែលគាត់បានធ្វើនោះដើម្បីមកបង្ហាញគឺកុមារនឹងអាចប្រើ telephone អាចប្រើជា recorder អីបានជា technology ដើម្បីឲ្យកុមារនឹងមានគេហៅថា
ាច record ទៅ product ដែលគាត់បានធ្វើទុកហ្នឹងដើម្បីបង្ហាញទៅគេវិញបាទបង្ហាញទៅថ្នាក់រៀនឬក៏បង្ហាញទៅមេដាបេដាអញ្ចឹងដែរបា
ទ Very good. So in okay, so these are some examples of greets that we can use to use in our classroom with children to describe different animals. So imagine that we are comparing different animals. Cows, is the sound of the cow high or low? Is it long or short? Is it quiet or loud? And then we compare different animals, and children need to think about these different characteristics. These are the same characteristics as in music, if you think about it. High or low, long or short, loud and quiet, this is exactly the same characteristics as in music, but we are using this language to allow children to really discover and understand the sounds that surround about us.
ចឹងតារាងមួយនេះគឺជាតារាងដែលនិយាយអំពីសំឡេងសត្វហើយវាមានភាពស្មុគស្មាញជាងតារាងមុនតិចដោយសារនៅក្នុងសំឡេងមួយហ្នឹងវាមានលក្ខណៈថាដូចថាសំឡេងគោហ្នឹងថាសំឡេងគោហ្នឹងវាឮខ្លាំងឬខ្សោយសំឡេងហ្នឹងវែងឬក៏ខ្លីសំឡេងឮខ្លាំងឬក៏គេថាស្ងាត់ស្ងៀមអញ្ចឹងកុមារនឹងអាចប្រៀបធៀបសម្លេងរវាងសត្វមួយទៅសត្វមួយនឹងបានដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់នឹងអាចគេថាមានជំនាញក្នុងការចំណាំនៅសម្លេងសត្វទាំងអស់នោះបា
ទ Very good. And so again, before I was talking about graphic scores, so we need to find ways, different ways to allow children to represent their knowledge. It can be with pictures, as here. It can be with invented notation, as in here. It can be like symbolic notation. They can compose a piece of music for different instruments, but everything will have a different color. So we need to give children the possibility to represent and compose their own music using different manners. Different representations, right? So here we can be very free, very open, because it's about creativity. So children can do this the way they want.
ចំណុចមួយទៀតនៅពេលដែលឲ្យលោកស្រីអាចបង្រៀនអំពីសូមឲ្យអ្នកគ្រូពេជ្រសេដាជួយបញ្ជាក់ទៀតបាទនៅពេលដែលនៅក្នុងរូបភាពនេះគឺជារូបភាពដែលបង្ហាញអំពី graphic score ហើយអរុស្រីអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងបង្ហាញអំពីរូបភាពដែលអាចតំណាងឲ្យសម្លេងជាមួយនឹងបានដូចជាភ្លៀងដូចជាខ្យល់អីចឹងណាហើយលោកស្រីអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងធ្វើការ note ឬក៏ធ្វើការគូរូបភាពតំណាងខ្លីៗឬក៏អាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងនៅក្នុងតារាងខាងក្រោមនេះគឺជាតារាងដែលតំណាងថាសំឡេងណាមួយដែលតំណាងឲ្យសំឡេងឧបករណ៍តន្ត្រីណាមួយអញ្ចឹងអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងគេហៅថារុករកឲ្យបាទ
So I'm finishing almost right so I think when it is possible it is important that especially when we work with preschool 2 preschool 3 children it is important that if possible we allow them to record in audio or in video what they create
ចឹងនៅក្នុងចឹងនៅក្នុងសកម្មភាពបន្តនេះគឺជាសកម្មភាពរូបភាពនេះគឺជារូបភាពដែលជាឧបករណ៍ record បានន័យថាជាឧបករណ៍ electronic smart record ចឹងអាចឲ្យកុមារនៅក្នុងកម្រិតអាយុpreschool 3អីហ្នឹងដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់នឹងអាចប្រើឧបករណ៍ electronic ហ្នឹងដើម្បីថតនៅសម្លេងឬក៏ថតនៅសកម្មភាពឬក៏ថតនៅគេថាអ្វីដែលគាត់រករកឃើញពីសម្លេងក្នុងធម្មជាតិហ្នឹងដើម្បីធ្វើជាឧបករណ៍ដែលគាត់យកអាចយកធ្វើផលិតជាតន្ត្រីបានបាទ
For example if you read a book to children and you ask them to compose the soundtrack for the book and investigate how to represent that book, that story with sound, it is important that they record it because they will be able to reflect about what they have done. This is really like important for teachers to document their learning. And then when we have many of these creations, this is important for us to have a sense of the development of children in terms of their creativity. So we can use a video camera, we can use phones, we can use audio recordings, anything that we have to document children learning is possible.
ចឹងគាត់ឧទាហរណ៍ឲ្យមួយនៅពេលដែលលោកស្រីអានរឿងនិទានឲ្យកុមារស្ដាប់ទៅហើយលោកស្រីឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងនិពន្ធនៅបទភ្លេងឬក៏និពន្ធនៅសំឡេងដែលមានការតំណតំណងនៅក្នុងរឿងនិទាននោះចឹងគាត់អាចប្រើឧបករណ៍ហ្នឹងដើម្បីឆ្លោះប្រចាំងហើយដើម្បីថតទុកតបមកទៀតអ្នកគ្រូអាចនៅពេលដែលគាត់ថតទុកហើយគាត់ធ្វើសលេងទៅតាមរឿងទាននឹងហើយយើងអាចបង្កើតទៅជាថាតន្ត្រីឬក៏សំឡេងដែលផ្សារភ្ជាប់ពាក់ព័ន្ធទៅនឹងរឿងនិទានរបស់យើងនឹងពេលនោះហើយដែលជាមានសារៈសំខាន់ដែលអ្នកគ្រូអាចរៀបចំជាគេហៅថាឯកសារមួយថាកុមារអាចធ្វើការនឹងបានតាមរយៈការបង្កើតថ្មីនឹងនេះហើយគឺជាសកម្មភាពនៃការអភិវឌ្ឍនៃការបង្កើតថ្មីនៅក្នុងការបង្រៀនតន្ត្រីនេះបាទ
Very good. So this is the last slide. So in summary, right? So to recap, what I'm trying to say in the first part of this workshop is that sound is a very, very important tool to foster the curiosity of children about the environment, right? It is very important for us as teachers to allow children to discover the world through sound.
Okay. អញ្ចឹងនេះជាស្លាយចុងបញ្ចប់ហើយគាត់សូមបញ្ជាក់ឡើងវិញថាសំឡេងតន្ត្រីគឺជាឧបករណ៍មួយដែលអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងអភិវឌ្ឍនៅជំនាញធៀបសពគ្រប់បីរៀននៅក្នុងបរិស្ថានស្វែងយល់ពីបរិស្ថានហើយវាជាឧបករណ៍មួយដែលអាចជួយឲ្យអ្នកអប់រំហ្នឹងអាចរៀបចំជាសកម្មភាពបង្រៀនឲ្យផ្សេងផ្សេងដើម្បីឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងមានការអភិវឌ្ឍនៅផ្នែកនេះបាទ
Okay, and these are the things that children can do with sound. They can listen to the sound, which is the very easy thing, just listen to it. They can also identify or recognize, but they can also compare different sounds and explain. They can analyze, imitate, and then they can do more difficult things like investigate different sounds, experiment, or they can compose and create things with sound.So as you can see, this goes from the most easy things to the most complex.
ហើយចំណុចដែលកុមារតូចអាចរៀនអំពីសំឡេងនឹងបានទីមួយគឺគេអាចស្ដាប់ធ្វើការគេចងចាំគេអាចបែងចែកឬក៏អាចចំណាំនៅក្នុងសំឡេងសត្វមនុស្សឬក៏សំឡេងប្រភេទគ្រឿងយន្តផ្សេងផ្សេងហើយគេអាចធ្វើការប្រៀបធៀបរវាងសំឡេងមួយទៅសំឡេងមួយគេអាចធ្វើការវិភាគហើយគេអាចធ្វើការត្រាប់តាមរយៈកាយវិការឬក៏តាមរយៈការធ្វើបញ្ចេញសំឡេងផ្សេងផ្សេងហើយគេអាចធ្វើការស៊ើបអង្កេតរករកសំឡេងនៅក្នុងធម្មជាតិហើយគេអាចធ្វើការពិសោធន៍ហើយយ៉ាងទៀតគឺគេអាចនិពន្ធឬអាចបង្កើតនៅសំឡេងផ្សេងផ្សេងនៅក្នុងធម្មជាតិនឹងបានដែរបាទ
Well, very good. Well, this is the end of my first part. In the second part of the workshop, I would like to talk about a very interesting sequence of listening that teachers can incorporate in the classroom.
ហើយយើងចូលដល់ផ្នែកទី2ហើយផ្នែកទី2នេះគឺជាគេហៅថាសកម្មភាពនៅក្នុងថ្នាក់រៀនដែលជាសកម្មភាពស្ដាប់ដែលមានភាពជាប្រចាំបាទសម្រាប់ថ្នាក់រៀនបាទ
Very good. One of the very important activities that preschool teachers need to do in class with children is to listen to music, is to listen to pieces of music as well.
ចឹងសកម្មភាពដែលមានសារៈសំខាន់នៅក្នុងថ្នាក់រៀនទី1គឺជាសកម្មភាពដែលកុមារគឺត្រូវស្ដាប់ទៅក្នុងស្ដាប់សំឡេងតន្ត្រីនៅក្នុងថ្នាក់រៀន
But listening to music is not only playing songs and just leaving the songs there to play.It is very important for teachers to do additional activities, additional steps to guide our children in perceiving the music more in more and more complex and sophisticated ways.
ចឹងសកម្មភាពស្ដាប់តន្ត្រីនៅក្នុងថ្នាក់រៀនវាមិនគ្រាន់តែឲ្យកុមារស្ដាប់តន្ត្រីឬក៏ឲ្យគាត់ចាក់តន្ត្រីស្ដាប់ខ្លួនឯងប៉ុណ្ណោះទេចឹងសកម្មភាពដែលត្រូវបន្ថែមទៅលើសកម្មភាពហ្នឹងគឺ គ្រូត្រូវឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងបានន័យថាបង្កើននៅការស្ដាប់ឬក៏បង្កើននៅការវិភាគអីផ្សេងផ្សេងតែភ្ជាប់ជាមួយនឹងការស្ដាប់តន្ត្រីហ្នឹងឲ្យវាមានភាពស្មុគស្មាញបន្ថែមជាងមុនទៀតបាទ
So this is very connected to the idea of active listening
ហើយនេះគឺជាសកម្មភាពដែលផ្សារភ្ជាប់ទៅជាមួយនឹងសកម្មភាពដែលគេហៅថាការស្ដាប់សកម្មបាទ
So imagine that you have a piece of music that you really like, a piece of music that you would like to share with your children in class.
ចឹងលោកស្រីត្រូវធ្វើការសមាសម័យនៅតន្ត្រីណាខ្លះដែលលោកស្រីគិតថាក្មេងចូលចិត្តស្ដាប់នៅក្នុងថ្នាក់រៀនបា
ទ So for as an example, I'm going to be using this piece that I really like. It's called The Carnival of the Animals. It's a very popular piece of music. It's a very, very, very nice piece of music introducing different animals with sound. It's called The Carnival of the Animals by Saint-Saëns, a French composer.
នេះគឺជាធនធានតន្ត្រីមួយដែលគាត់លើកឧទាហរណ៍មកចង់ចាប់បង្ហាញដែលជាប្រភពមកពីប្រទេសបារាំងដែលមានឈ្មោះថា Carnival of Animals ហើយវាមានភាពល្បីល្បាញមែនទែនសម្រាប់ថ្នាក់មត្តេយ្យសិក្សាបាទ
This piece is very popular in schools and preschools all over the world.
ហើយវាមានភាពល្បីល្បាញខ្លាំងមែនទែននៅក្នុងថ្នាក់មត្តេយ្យសិក្សាហើយនិងសាលាផ្សេងៗនៅក្នុងពិភពលោកបាទ
So what I'm going to tell you, what I'm going to share with you today is a sequence, a listening sequence, some activities that you can go to introduce music and to do active listening with your children.
Why ដែលគាត់ចង់បញ្ជាក់នេះគឺជាសកម្មភាពស្ដាប់ដែលមានជាលក្ខណៈជាប្រព័ន្ធជា sequence បាទដែលលោកស្រីត្រូវយកទៅប្រើឬក៏យកទៅធ្វើជាមួយនឹងកុមារតូចនៅក្នុងកម្រិតមត្តេយ្យរបស់យើងហ្នឹងបាទ
And this sequence can be applied to any other song, any other piece of music. It can be really any other piece of music is fine also.
Hi, a piep sequence នេះបានន័យថាភាពបន្ទាក់គ្នានេះគឺជាអ្វីដែលគាត់ចង់ប្រាប់ថាវាយកមកប្រើនៅក្នុងតន្ត្រីហើយវាមានសារៈសំខាន់មែនទែនបា
ទ Okay. So the first step when we are doing active listening is we can call it prepare. So we are going to do preparation work, right? So we need to introduce and contextualize the music to our children. There are many things we can do to contextualize and to introduce. For example, we can talk about the composer. We can tell children about the life of the composer, the country where the composer was born, the style of the music. So we are going to prepare children to listen to this piece of music, tell them something about it.
ជំហានទី1នៃសកម្មភាព sequence listening នេះគឺយើងត្រូវរៀបចំអានេះថានៅពេលដែលយើងរៀបចំហ្នឹងដូចគាត់លើកឧទាហរណ៍ថាដូចជាយើងអាចប្រាប់ឈ្មោះអ្នកនិពន្ធអាចប្រាប់ពីប្រភពអ្នកនិពន្ធគាត់មកពីជីវិតរបស់អ្នកនិពន្ធគាត់មកពីទីក្រុងឬជនបទឬក៏ជីវិតនៃការរស់នៅរបស់គាត់វាមិនគឺដើម្បីតាក់ទាញកុមារក្នុងការឲ្យចូលស្ដាប់នៅតន្ត្រីនេះតែម្ដងបាទយើងរៀបចំកុមារដើម្បីធ្វើការស្ដាប់បា
ទ So imagine for example that we are going to talk to our children about the composer of this piece of music who happens to be Saint-Saëns, this composer that we have over here, right? So imagine.
ចឹងនេះគឺជាឧទាហរណ៍ដែលគាត់នេះគឺជាការលើកឧទាហរណ៍ដែលគាត់បង្ហាញអំពីអ្នកនិពន្ធមួយដែលឲ្យដូចគាត់ប្រាប់ពីខាងដើមចឹងថានៅជំនាញទី1គឺយើងត្រូវប្រាប់ឈ្មោះនៃនិពន្ធដើម្បីតាក់ទាញកុមារហ្នឹងអាចចូលស្ដាប់នៅតន្ត្រីរបស់គាត់ចឹងនេះគឺជាវីដេអូដែលគាត់បង្ហាញហ្នឹងបាទ
So imagine that we just share a video with them about the life of the composer, a video that is going to share very basic information about the composer and the context.
នេះគឺជាវីដេអូដែលគាត់បង្ហាញអំពីជីវប្រវត្តិសង្ខេបរបស់អ្នកនិពន្ធនៅក្នុងការបង្កើតតន្ត្រីរបស់គាត់នឹងបាទ
Let me just play this video as an example.
Camille Saint-Saëns was born on October 9th, 1835, in Paris, France. A child prodigy, his mother and aunt began teaching him piano at the age of only 2, and by age 3, he was already composing his own works. Furthermore, by age 10, he was performing concertos by Beethoven and Mozart. Aside from being an outstanding pianist, he was also an amateur scientist, a poet, an essayist, and dramatist who showed interest in other subjects such as philosophy, geology, astronomy, and archaeology. In 1857, he was appointed organist at the Madeleine Church in Paris, a position which he held for 20 years. Fellow composer Franz Liszt said that Saint-Saëns was the greatest composer in the world after hearing him improvise. Saint-Saëns assembled a very large library of musical compositions throughout his career, which included choral and keyboard works, symphonic poems including Danse Macabre and Carnival of Animals, operas, incidental music such as Samson and Delilah, symphonies, and concertos. Camille Saint-Saëns died on September 16, 1921 in Algiers, Algeria at the age of 86.
Right. So imagine that you start telling children about something that introduces the music. It can be the composer, but it can be many other aspects. So the first step would be to prepare, right? Then the second step would be to listen to the piece of music. So then after you have introduced, you're going to play for the first time the recording, right, to children. And then you can talk to children about how they feel about that piece of music. So come.
Chúng xong một số cho chọn chấm hai nơi về đại dương môn đường chập đàm ở cùng mà sắp đến trái từ dương trời riệp chầm đường chia
You would be playing part of the music to children. Of course, this piece is very long. I am only going to play a couple of parts of the music. So come.
Chang, pesa, bot chum riêng, bot chum trai ni kư miên dạ pe vén kư quan ng chạm nai khla ao kum a sạp, ao long sạy sạp. Chang, lu sạy ai thua đôi kini chạm nai, nơi pe da chum riêng nào vén, nhưng ai chạm nai khla.
You could tell children in this piece, the composer is introducing different animals, right? This is why it's called the carnival. So, and you could just play some of the animals. For example, I'm going to play just the lion, and then I will play aquarium, which involves fish, right? So imagine, I'm going to now try to play these two.
Chúng lô sợi ai prap cục mà thà nơi khnông xài carnival nếu vì miền sầm lề sạt trán hay lộ nó bên ít còn chạm tay sầm lề bí thế cứ sầm lề nhà táo hay là sầm lề nhà corin là chia này chia sẵn mỗi nơi chia trời đây nè.
Alright, so I'm gonna try and play this song. Is it introduction? The introduction. And now is the lions, right? So now the piece that comes now is about lions, right? So it's going to be a march, right?
All
right. Thank you. So you could play the song, and when you finish the lion's part, you could ask children, why do you think it sounds like a lion? What makes you believe that this is actually a lion? Can you tell me with your words, and have a conversation with children, asking them to explain why, what is it that makes them think of lions when they play this song?
វាមានផ្នែកណាខ្លះដែលដូចនឹងសំឡេងតោហ្នឹងហើយអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងបញ្ចូលមកវិញហើយយើងអាចធ្វើការសន្ទនានៅផ្នែកនឹងតែម្ដងបាទ
Right. And after you had a conversation with children about why that part sounds like a lion or lions, then you can play another very different piece, which is the aquarium.
ចឹងនៅពេលដែលលោកស្រីភាសានឹងសន្តានាជាប់ជាមួយកុមារហើយលោកស្រីនឹងអាចចាក់ផ្នែកទី2បន្តទៀតគឺ aquarium នឹងយើងអាចធ្វើសកម្មភាពដូចគ្នាបន្តបន្តដូចនេះបាទ
So I'll play now for you aquarium for you to see how it sounds
ជឹងគាត់នឹងចាក់ផ្នែក aquarium នឹងឯងដើម្បីឲ្យលោកស្រីអាចធ្វើការស្ដាប់នឹងបាទ
So you would go with children, listen to the whole aquarium, and then, like I said, you could really have a discussion with your children and ask them to really explain with their own words what makes them believe that this is an aquarium with fish, and they can have a discussion, they can really explain in words what they perceive from the music. So come.
អញ្ចឹងនៅពេលដែលអលោកស្រីចាក់ចម្រៀងផ្នែក aquarium អស់នឹងហើយលោកស្រីអាចធ្វើការពិភាក្សាគ្នាហើយអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងបង្ហាញនៅអារម្មណ៍របស់គេថាហេតុអីបានជាសំឡេងហ្នឹងយើងអាចចាត់ទុកថាជាសំឡេង aquarium ហ្នឹងនេះហើយគឺជាគេហៅថាឲ្យក្មេងហ្នឹងអាចធ្វើការសមាសម័យនិងអាចនិយាយចេញមកវិញសំដែងចេញមកវិញនៅអ្វីដែលគេបានគិតហ្នឹងបាទ
Then step number 3, we call it active and participate. So now children will listen again to the song and they are going to be more actively involved in performing or moving to the music. So now it's not going to be just explaining with words. They are going to be doing something. They are going to be moving with their bodies. They can be imitating something, being more participatory.With their whole body in the music.
ចឹងជំហានទី3គឺជាជំហានដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងការធ្វើសកម្មភាពហើយនឹងការចូលរួមហើយយើងមើលសកម្មភាពទី2គឺជាសកម្មភាពដែលគាត់ចូលរួមសម្ដែងប្រើតែមាត់ទេប៉ុន្តែសកម្មភាពនេះគឺជាសកម្មភាពដែលឲ្យកុមារនឹងសម្ដែងហើយនឹងប្រើកាយវិការឬក៏ប្រើគេហៅថារាងកាយពេញទាំងអស់របស់កុមារតែម្ដងដើម្បីឲ្យគេហៅថាមានភាពសកម្មក្នុងការចូលកម្មវិធីនេះបាទ Okay finish
So see that this is not only just listening playing the song and listening this is much more than just listening so we are contextualizing the music step 1 then we are listening to the music having discussion expressing what we perceive and now the children are going to be more engaged in the performance
អញ្ចឹងយើងមានជំហានតាំងពីទី1ទី2ហើយរហូតដល់ទី3នេះគឺ dương khơi tha dương miên đồng nạn ca bỏ kế hay đồng nạn ca thị bấy nó cứ chỉ đồng nạn ca đại thường cho rùm tiền xong tiền đón chẳng cứ dương miên rùm biếp cái hai tha tiện tiền nhỏ của mà cho rùm nơi khăn ông cảm hiệp này và tất cả đồng nạn ca tiền đón.
Very good. So let me show you an example of how they do something in this classroom. So it's an example of children also listening to the carnival, and you're gonna see how they move according to the music.
Chẳng nên cứ chia sẻ cam phết để cọt vào bằng hàng thợ rèn muối để miền cổ mà để bán sắp từ chấm riêng rồi có play nhà carnival mình nhận tới ta tới cái miền cam phết đến đánh dù xây ai chui tam đàn ngọc thế tới bạn.
When that fish goes down again, listen to the music.
So as you can see in the video, there is quite a lot of free expression, right? So children are expressing what they hear freely with their bodies, and they are representing the music as they move.
Chẳng ở lúc này khởi như là con ông rục hiệp nông bình tổ nên cứ cô má tới ban gà thà thơ sẽ cảm hiệp chẳng sở rấy tới ta mà bởi đại kê lứ hay khởi như cô má cứ miên ca trói tốp tới nâng đòn trấy nâng play nhưng đã kể lưu nó cứ phơi tờ tạm cảm hiệp
So imagine that then you also ask them to dance according to the lion, right? The lion was very different. The lion was very energetic. The lion was a march. So you could ask them to then move according to the lion and then see how they compare the fish and the lions.
Chẳng lộ xây cho trong trăm tháng ở bên này lưu sở lên tàu nó cứ dừng bằng ai ai của mà rùm mà này bằng đáy dừng ai ai của mà nó thưa sự cảm tiếp được cài và cả nó đã đôi những tàu hay dừng ai ai của mà nó tiếp tiếp được viên cả thưa sự cảm tiếp được tàu nâng cả thưa sự cảm tiếp được trời ở Korean để play như tam trời ở Korean nâng nữa.
So after you could have another question and discussion session in step number four. And then you could ask children about their emotional responses to the music. So when they are dancing, when they are moving according to the music in that way, how do they feel? Why do they move that way? What is the emotions that they are experiencing? And you can have a conversation with them about how the music made them feel.
អញ្ចឹងដំណាក់កាលទី4ជំនាញទី4គឺជាដំណាក់កាលសំណួរនិងការពិភាក្សាអញ្ចឹងយើងអាចពិភាក្សាជាមួយកុមារនៅពេលដែលគេធ្វើសកម្មភាពតាមតន្ត្រីនឹងចប់ហើយថាតើគេមានអារម្មណ៍ឆ្លើយតបឬក៏អារម្មណ៍របៀបមួយដែរនៅពេលដែលគេបានធ្វើកាយវិការឬក៏បានស្ដាប់តន្ត្រីនឹងអញ្ចឹងនេះគឺជាកិច្ចពិភាក្សាដើម្បីឲ្យកុមារនឹងគេថាមានបទពិសោធន៍បន្ថែមទៅលើតន្ត្រីដែលគេបានស្ដាប់ឬគេបានធ្វើចលនាតាមនឹងបាទ
Right.So after the discussion, also, you could listen again to the recording and then maybe try to ask children to notice more and more subtle elements of the music and familiar moments of the music. Try to go more deeper into what they are listening to and try to slowly ask them to explain in words how they...perceive the music and the characteristics of the music. Is it loud? Is it soft? Is it kind? Is it aggressive? So teachers can ask slowly children to use more and more and more and more sophisticated language to describe what they perceive in the music, the elements they perceive.
Chúng chấm hiên tí 5 cứ bẹp pon đó cả đập đàn trầy nhưng làng bình xa tiết cứ chừng crew này crew ai chạy đàn trầy nhưng làng bình xa tiết thì chừng ai chạy đã dư dư để lươn lươn hay chừng ai xua cục mà bởi dồn biện nơi cái lại ná đầm bầy cục mà đọt dồn hay chừng ai chờ ai cục mà nâng gà ta đập nơi element rồi bỏ đàn trầy nâng ta đàn trầy nâng bình miên kẻ thà lươn dư rư có xâm mẹp kẻ thà đàn trầy nâng vì ai chạy một ca chứ được có slow đấy chứ nè mở bị ạ tạ chứ được bỏ đồng trầy chứ nè nên cứ chỉ những ai phía xa hay những xua của mà nó không cũng lòng phê để sạch đăng vào nhìn.
And then finally the last step of the sequence is we could also ask children to create something based on this music. So it is not only listening, in the end children are going to be creating something new based on the music. So for example, they could compose music of the similar type. Imagine that you ask them to compose another piece for lions and another piece for aquarium. And they will have to find ways with instruments or with objects or with sound from the environment to represent lions and to represent fish, right? Maybe lions could be trucks. Maybe fish could be a beach, for example, right? So you could also ask, you could do different kinds of activities.
Mùi nâng cứ bẹp bọn nâng ca bùng rịt nâng ca sạp nâng lô sợi ác ai cục mà nâng thà thà bạc cao nâng nịpun nâng bọt lê như rưu con nịpun nâng trầm riêng ai xem xế nâng sạch điên nâng vầy đề bàn sạp nâng rưu có ai bạc cao tư chìa thà thà này mùi để chia đồng trầy để sử dụng đồng tao để sử dụng đồng trầy nâng để tam ở quấy nâng phần bản thân thông chiếc để kê bàn tổ thuộc bọc về sau nâng cứ ai cho kê nâng nhịp bốn rồi có ai cho kê nâng riêng phơ plên thơ mây nâng bây ở sử dụng đồng quấy để kê bàn riêng sốt nhịp bàn sử dụng nhịp bàn.
Very good. So the important thing here is that we not only listen to the song, to the piece of music several times, also that we engage children in conversations, in actions when they dance and move, and also in creating something based on the piece of music, and we extend and they compose and create something at the end.
Chúng cam phê bằng lên đàn trai, dương mình còn đã chặt đàn trai, ai cũng mà sắp hai chuyện tam và nói tới dương ai ai cũng mà nâng thơ cam phê cài với cá, rồi gọi ai thơ cài với xa. Khnia tập vinh tập mốt ông pi tập hợp đơn trai tập hết đơn trai rồi có ai dạy ông pi cái hạt ta tập chật rồi có element đơn trai nè hỏi những ai ao cụ mà nè ai bậc cao tham mây từ lơ rồi có ai cùng đi nơi cả trong chợ đăng bảo kê nè tam dạ cả ni pon bọn chấm điểm tham mây đại sự điểm nâng vây đại cọt bàn riêng sốt nè.
I would like to share with you also some different kinds of lesson ideas that preschool teachers can use in their classroom to teach about different musical concepts, right? About the musical elements.
In chung kot nang bachop bot banhan bang kot nou knong royeak pe 15 nati tiet ha che nang aich tok pe lo srei nang thveu ka phiesa nang suor somnoy nou avai dae aich dok srong yo teu parien nou knong thnak bo khruon ai ban.
So imagine that we are in our classroom talking with our children about loud and soft, sounds that are loud and sounds that are very soft, to teach children about those concepts.
Chăng ni cứ chia cầm nát muối chia cồm nón muối nè con thằng nào riết này say ai người riết cụ má rồi chầm nằm sầm lề ná đại sầm lề lư sầm lề ná đại sầm lề nhờ cái hạt thà ngọc ngát rồi có nè con nón đồng trai và.
So possible activities that we can do is, for example, we could ask our children to match the dynamics of these different pieces of music with pictures or with photographs, right? So of different characters. So we could talk about soft and loud and then find pictures that resonate with the idea of loud and soft, right? So just find images that sound loud, images, pictures that sound like soft.
Chăng lô srei aj aoy kuma toj thvoe ka priep thiep rư ko thvoe chamnat thna match khnie yeng chmuoy ning samleng tau ning rup khiep rư ko tau ning eriya bot ai phseng phseng dael doch uthahor chăng tha samleng lư rư ko samleng sngiem sngat nang vi mien akara rư ko mien ke tha rup khiep rư ko mien akara baep mịch tau chmuoy ning sat rư ko chmuoy manuh ai biep mịch da ba yeng kư kru kư aoy aj aoy kuman thvoe sakam phiep nang bathaem.
Another possible activity could be sing a song softly and have children like tiptoe into the song, moving very quiet, quiet, quiet. And then we can repeat the song with a much, much higher volume and then having children marching to make the gestures and to make the body movement of being very loud. So we play the same song soft and loud and we ask children to move loud and soft.
Hay skam phie bto tiet keu jeung aaj oy kuma jeung neak kru nung chak chamrieng pe tha tik tik hay oy kuma nung thveu skam phie tam hay jeung aaj thveu chak chamrieng bto tiet chak chamrieng khlang hay oy kuma nung thveu tam skam phie hay jeung aaj thveu skam phie chak khlang chak tik nung te tam nung hay oy kuma thveu skam phie rư ko aaj thveu chalana nung te tam chamrieng nung neak knong thnak nung.
A third idea, we could play two pieces of music that are very different. One is very soft, another one is very loud. Then we can ask children to compare the two pieces of music. And then again, we can ask them to listen to them, talking about what they hear, describing with their own words, and then moving to the music, moving according to what they hear and express with their bodies what they are hearing.
ចំណុចទី3នេះគឺសកម្មភាពគ្រូអាចរៀបចំជាសកម្មភាពចាក់តន្ត្រីជាពីរផ្សេងនេះបើថាយើងចាក់មួយលឺមួយខ្សោយអញ្ចឹងទៅហើយឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងស្ដាប់ហើយយើងអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងជជែកឬក៏វែកញែកថាតើពេលយើងស្ដាប់ខាងលឺហ្នឹងលឺរបៀបម៉េចហើយខាងខ្សោយរបៀបម៉េចហើយបន្ទាប់មកយើងឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងធ្វើចលនាទៅតាមតន្ត្រីទាំងពីរហ្នឹងបាទ.
Very good. And finally, we can also use, for example, pictures or photographs to represent the dynamics of music, right? So remember that here we are talking about loud and soft, right? So we could use images as a way to talk with children about loud and soft. What does it mean? Talk about the images and have children match them with different sections of the music, right? So in a way, when children do these kind of activities, they have to think deeper. They have to make connections between images and sound, right? And they have to really justify their choices. And this makes them think much more and much deeper about sound.
ចំណុចទី4គឺពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងការប្រើប្រាស់រូបភាពឬក៏ប្រើប្រាស់រូបថតដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងបទចម្រៀងហើយដោយលោកស្រីឃើញខាងលើហើយគឺជាឧទាហរណ៍មួយដែលគាត់លើកយករូបភាពដែលពាក់ព័ន្ធនឹងសម្ដែងលឺនិងសម្ដែងខ្សោយណាហើយការដែលធ្វើបែបនេះគឺអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងអាចធ្វើការសមាសម័យឬក៏អាចគេថាមានចំណេះដឹងបន្ថែមបទពិសោធន៍បន្ថែមទៅលើចម្រៀងទៅលើបទភ្លេងនោះថាសម្ដែងណាដែលលឺនឹងសម្ដែងណាដែលខ្សោយដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់នឹងអាចគេថាមាន head poll ដើម្បីបញ្យលមកវិញបាទបញ្យលមកមនុស្សធំវិញ.
For example, we show children a picture of a beach in Cambodia, for example, a very quiet beach. Then we show them a picture of a city of Phnom Penh, a big city with a lot of cars, and then we ask children to use instruments or objects to make the sound of a beach, to make the sound of a big city. How do they create those sounds? How do they explore their creativity to make it sound like a beach, make it sound like a city, right? So in this process of creation, they really will have to investigate about sound.
ចឹងឲ្យឧទាហរណ៍មួយឧទាហរណ៍ថាយើងបង្ហាញរូបភាពឆ្នេរសមុទ្រមានភាពស្ងប់ស្ងាត់នៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាហើយនឹង រូបភាពទីក្រុងនៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាហ្នឹងទីក្រុងភ្នំពេញហ្នឹងអញ្ចឹងតមកយើងឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងបង្កើតជាសម្លេងទៅតាមរូបភាពហ្នឹងទីក្រុងហើយនឹងហើយនឹងឆ្នេរហ្នឹងតមកយើងអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងគឺធ្វើការបញ្ចូលយើងមកវិញថាតើហេតុអីបានជាសម្លេងនៅក្នុងទីក្រុងហ្នឹងរបៀបហ្នឹងសម្លេងនៅសមុទ្ររបៀបហ្នឹងអានេះហើយគឺជាផ្នែកមួយនៃការបង្កើតថ្មីក្នុងការបង្រៀនតន្ត្រីនេះបាទ
So yeah. Now it is very important also to know about children's preferences, right? So normally children will have their own musical preferences. It is very important that us as teachers try to introduce to the classroom a wide range of music styles, right? So try to bring to the classroom styles that maybe children don't have the opportunity to listen at home.
ចឹងចំណុចនេះគឺចង់និយាយអំពីចំណងចំណូលចិត្តនៃការស្ដាប់តន្ត្រីរបស់កុមារតូចហើយយើងគិតថាកុមារតូចហ្នឹងវាអាចយ៉ាងនេះដែរប៉ុន្តែបើសិនជានេះយើងអាចឲ្យកុមារនេះបង្កើនចំណងចំណូលចិត្តហ្នឹងស្ដាប់នៅផ្ទះបន្ថែមទៀតបាទ
So it is important to bring to the classroom a wide range of music, a wide range of styles and genders and cultures.
ហើយវាមានសារៈសំខាន់ណាស់ដែលអាចឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងនាំមកថ្នាក់រៀនវិញនៅគេថាភាពទូលំទូលាយនៃគេហៅថាភេទឬក៏នៃ style ផ្សេងផ្សេងហ្នឹងបាទ
So, for example, the music piece of the Carnival of the Animals, probably many children in Cambodia don't have the opportunity to listen to that music at home. So as teachers, we need to identify these pieces of music and bring it to the classroom to share with our children and give them the opportunity to be exposed to this music because they probably don't have the chance to listen to it at home.
អញ្ចឹងគាត់ថាប្រហែលជានៅក្នុងប្រទេសកម្ពុជាកុមារតូចភាគច្រើនគឺមិនបានមានឱកាសស្ដាប់ភ្លេងការណាវលហ្នឹងមិនទេអញ្ចឹងក្នុងនាមជាគ្រូត្រីអាចរៀបចំផ្នែកនៃតន្ត្រីហ្នឹងអាចឲ្យចាក់ឲ្យកុមារស្ដាប់នៅក្នុងថ្នាក់រៀនទៅដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់មានឱកាសក្នុងការស្ដាប់នៅតន្ត្រីឬក៏នៅផ្នែកអស់ហ្នឹងហើយអាចឲ្យគាត់ធ្វើការសមាសម័យទៅតាមអ្វីដែលគាត់បញ្ចូលពីខាងដើមមកហ្នឹងបាទ
Probably children don't love necessarily this music that you bring but as teachers we also can widen their spectrum of preferences so if we bring that music to the classroom we are really doing the work of expanding the receptive experiences that children are going to have. So it is very important to bring music that probably is not their favorite, but using that music to foster their perception and their creativity.
ចឹងគាត់បញ្ជាក់ចំណុចមួយទៀតដែរថាប្រហែលជាកុមារតូចហ្នឹងវាមិនអាចចូលចិត្តតន្ត្រីដែលចាក់ដោយគ្រូបរៀនទាំងអស់នោះទេអញ្ចឹងក្នុងនាមជាគ្រូបរៀនយើងអាចគេថាស្វែងរកតន្ត្រីណាដែលយើងអាចពិនិត្យមើលទៅអាចស្វែងរកតន្ត្រីណាដែលធ្វើឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងមានការចូលចិត្តភាគច្រើនអញ្ចឹងយើងអាចយកមក play ទៅដើម្បីឲ្យគាត់បង្កើននៅចំណងចំណូលចិត្តនៃការស្ដាប់តន្ត្រីហ្នឹងរបស់កុមារបន្ថែមទៀតដែរ
All right well just to finish with some recommendations for preschool teachers it is important to listen to music regularly with children
អញ្ចឹងនេះគឺជាអនុសាសន៍មួយចំនួនសម្រាប់គ្រូមតិសិក្សាទី1គឺសូមឲ្យលោកស្រីហ្នឹងចាក់តន្ត្រីស្ដាប់ជាមួយកុមារហ្នឹងឲ្យមានភាពជាប្រចាំបាទ
And it's important to bring to the classroom music that is more complex than the music that they normally hear at home The music that they play on TV, for example, it's important to bring music that is a little bit more sophisticated and complex.
អញ្ចឹងចំណុចមួយទៀតគឺអលោកស្រីត្រូវចងចាំដែរថាសូមឲ្យនាំនៅតន្ត្រីណាដែល chấp đam miền phiệp smok smang tới miền phiệp smok smang tới nó cũng ơi sđap ta đần trầy na đai quọt lư rọ ngai nơ tẻ chăng na ba.
It is also very important to listen to music several times, not to just play a piece of music once, but to play it multiple times, because it's when children are going to exercise their perception and become more and more sensitive to the music. So it is important to play it multiple times.
Chăng chuẩn nói tiếp cứ cột ở anh sa đấy thà chấm riêng đồng trai môi nó cứ giờ mình ai chạm làm đón đấy cứ xong ở chạm bàn tràn đón đồng bay ở bậc cao nơi cả chạm và róm rồi còn bậc cao nơi bọt bị sọt xem là cô mà tôi bao giờ nữa.
It is important to engage children in conversations with others and justifying and explaining what they hear, what they perceive, because these discussions will give them the conceptual tools to explain how they perceive music in a more and more and more refined way.
Chúng chúng nói tí bấy cứ so mà lô sợi nơi bây giờ chạm trái hay cứ so mà xua xùm nua hay bị phiện xa cho mỗi của mà tốt thà nơi ở rõm bỏ kê rồi còn nơi bọt bởi sót bỏ kê nơi bây giờ kê sạp thường trái nâng. Vì cứ chi cái hệ thả ô bà co mỗi đẹp bạc ca nơi cái hệ thả cùng đất tròn chám xâm rạp của mà tốt mà.
It is important that we don't judge the preferences of children.
Ai cho nói tí bốn cứ lộ sợi cứ ở cắt sợi đây tha khmer những thời cho bị cho chặt đây cho chặt chầm riêng này cho chặt chầm riêng nô thế ở cắt sợi đây để bà lại nè.
As mentioned before, it is always very very important that when we are doing music education, in the end children also document what they are creating with an audio recording, with a video camera, with a phone, with any device, especially when they are creating something new, because this is a this is their own documentation of the creative development.
Hay cho nó mỗi tiết nữa cứ miễn sao sầm khăn mình tên nơi về đài cổ mà bạc cả nơi video record rồi có record ấy xem xem nơi từ lơ anh trai để cái bàn bạc cả đấy cứ cụ từ ra ai cái xa năng tốt làm bài tốt chi đọc cho mình xem nhạc kê bàn.
And finally, it's very important when we talk with children about how music makes us feel, right? Music conveys emotions and feelings. So it's very important to really ask children to explain their own emotions and feelings when they listen to music as well.
Hay cho nó trong cái cứ đồn trái cứ chỉ cả bậc cả nơi ở rom ấy xem xét tam bậc hết nu chẳng complete ở sót nơi bề đài aoi cũng mà sắp đồn trái hỏi cứ từng thời xưa thằng ta rom là bậc kê chúng bộ đồn trái nó miền mẹ rõm chẳng mạch chẳng mạch chẳng ok xung đại anh chánh rồi còn về chánh màu bàn.
Well, so thank you so much Sokom for your translation. This is all I had prepared for the workshop today. Now it's time for questions. If anybody would like to clarify something or ask any follow-up questions, now it's time for that.
Chẳng quạt bàn và chọc nằm bằng hai bó quạt trong lời dạ bê mới thức ngay đi hỏi hay bà sân bà ở lộ sầy miền sầm nua away để trong bệnh trạng cốt sầm chơi và hay có miền anusa rồi có miền cầm đặt ấy trong bệnh bệnh thái mà sầm chơi và
thank you Dr. Alfredo, thank you for sharing your knowledge and wisdom, and we hope that our participants will find these techniques, tools and activities helpful while teaching in their preschools. So before going to the question answer sessions, I would really like to highlight two important things. One is the feedback. We would really request you all to give us your feedback. That is important for us. And last time we found very important suggestions and recommendations for organizing different type of topics and sessions for the future. So we will try to help you in different ways and organize those sessions in the future. And the second thing is about our upcoming next workshop in January.
Chúng còn một lần đo chúng tôi nói còn miền chúng nói bấy để trong bạch trẻ lộ sấy chúng nói tí muối cứ ca oi anusa feedback từ lời ca riệp trong sikha sala này hay pi sikha sala mun keu kot ban totuol neu bot pisot nang feedback ban yang lo hay som a lo srei bto oy anosah dambei kae lom o sikha sala jeung bathaem tiet hay chnoy ti 2 keu kot nang bjeak bathaem ampi workshop ba jeung neu khae kraoy keu neu nong khae makara ba chnam 2023
ba. And our next workshop is on 14th of January, same time, Saturday, Cambodian time on Zoom. And it's about mathematics learning in early years by Dr. Sanjay.
Hi, Skansala, I think at 2023, ប្រធានបទនៅក្នុង workshop ដែលក្រោយហ្នឹងគឺផ្ដោតទៅលើការរៀនគណិតវិទ្យានៅកម្រិតមតិសិក្សាបា
ទ Thanks for correction Sukom it's 2023 not 2022 January so next year okay so let's start our question and answer sessions if you have any questions you may raise your hand and or ask raise your hand we will one of our team members would highlight unmute you and you can ask question either in English or Khmer our translators would help us communicate in English please and secondly you can also write down your question in the chat box either in English or Khmer language so far I have got one question in English Alfredo that is about one of the participants named Linda Hope. Yeah. She's, I think, who or she, whoever it is, he is or she is. She says, what subject should we integrate music in? The first part of the question is. And the second is, and how long we can use music activities in that subject or in that school classroom activity?
អញ្ចឹងរបៀបសួរសំណួរលោកស្រីអាចសួរជាពីរបែបបានទី1គឺលោកស្រីអាចលើកដៃសួរនៅក្នុងអង្គប្រជុំនេះតែម្ដងគឺសួរជាភាសាខ្មែរក៏បានអង់គ្លេសក៏បានបើសួរជាភាសាខ្មែរគឺមានបកប្រែជូនហើយចំណុចទី2គឺលោកស្រីអាចសរសេរនៅក្នុង chat box បាននៅពេលនេះគឺយើងមានសំណួរមួយពីលោកស្រីហុកលីណាគាត់សួរថាតើយើងបញ្ចូលខ្លឹមសារបង្រៀនតន្ត្រីនេះទៅក្នុងមុខវិជ្ជាអីហើយប្រើពេលប្រមាណហើយប្រើពេលប្រមាណសម្រាប់មុខវិជ្ជាតន្ត្រីនេះបា
ទ music really can be integrated with all subjects in music is very easy to integrate today I was talking mainly about integration so music can be also integrated with language it's very easy to use music and teach songs to children to introduce to new vocabulary. For example, it is very easy to use music to teach children about mathematics. Music is pure mathematics. So music can, to answer the first part of the question, music can be really integrated with all subjects. Music can be integrated with motor development when we do music and movement activities. So we as educators can potentially integrate music with everything in very, very simply.
អញ្ចឹងគាត់ឆ្លើយសំណួរផ្នែកទី1សិនគឺតន្ត្រីគឺអាចបញ្ចូលបាននៅក្នុងគ្រប់សកម្មភាពនៅក្នុងមតិសាសាគាត់លើកឧទាហរណ៍ថាអាចបញ្ចូលបាននៅក្នុងភាសាក៏បានភាសាអាចមានផ្សារភ្ជាប់ជាមួយនឹងពាក្យអីផ្សេងៗហើយយើងអាចផ្សារភ្ជាប់ទៅក្នុងសកម្មភាពគណិតវិទ្យាអីក៏បានហើយអាចជាពិសេសគឺអាចផ្សារភ្ជាប់ទៅក្នុងសកម្មភាពចិត្តចលភាពដោយសារយើងមានហាត់ប្រាណតាមរឿងទានរឿងមានហាត់ប្រាណតាមចម្រៀងអីផ្សេងៗនោះបាទនេះគឺជាការឆ្លើយនៅផ្នែកទី1បាទ
And then for the second part of the question how long should be do music I would say as long as possible.
Okay.
I mean it depends on how long we have in our classrooms, but music really facilitate other learnings, right? So when we are teaching other things, we can really teach through songs. It depends on how skillful the teacher is, but really music can be used as a vehicle to teach about many other subjects. So we could potentially teach all the time with music, right? So it's just a matter of whether teachers know how to do it. But my answer to your second question is as long as possible.
Okay. ចំឡើយសម្រាប់សំណួរនៅផ្នែកទី2គឺទៅប្រើរយៈពេលប្រហែលគាត់ឆ្លើយថាប្រើកាន់តែយូរកាន់តែល្អដោយសារអីដោយសារតន្ត្រីវាអាចសម្របសម្រួលនឹងការរៀនគ្រប់មុខវិជ្ជាអញ្ចឹងទៅធ្វើឲ្យវាអាចប្រើប្រាស់ជាឧបករណ៍សម្រាប់ឲ្យកុមារនឹងមានការចងចាំទៅលើខ្លឹមសារមេរៀនអីមួយមួយអញ្ចឹងណាអញ្ចឹងគាត់ឆ្លើយអង់គ្លេសថាប្រើកាន់តែយូរកាន់តែល្អប៉ុន្តែវាអាចសរុបស្រួលទៅម៉ោងសិក្សាទៅតាមការវិភាគរបស់អ្នកគ្រូអ្នកគ្រូម្នាក់ៗទៅតាមអ្វីដែលបានកំណត់ទាំងដែរបា
ទ any other questions any other comments
ចឹងមានសំណួរបន្ថែមទៀតទេបាទលោកស្រីខាងណាដែលលើកដៃ iPhone នេះបាទសូមអញ្ជើញបាទ Madam Hoglinda also continue her question
yes
should it start in the beginning or the last session
so there are no rules, right? So my advice is that really music could be just the very beginning of every day. And music also should be the way to say goodbye also. In fact, later I want to play a song. So music can be used all the time throughout the day. Sometimes as a classroom management strategy, and sometimes we may want to do a music activity, but there's no rules. Ideally, as much as possible.
Chung got Linda got so but time tha yung ai prao neu maung dabong rư ko ai prao neu maung chong kroy bantae got chloy veng tha vi ot mien rule ay dae bacheak rung nang ne yung ai prao neu maung na ko ban dae doich got chung kư got prao tang maung chol tang prao tang maung chen doich yung chap dam dabong yung mien chamrieng hay chong bachop ko got mien chamrieng muoy dae chung aich a prao neu knong sach knong pe barien nang ko ban dae chung got aich bacheak tha តន្ត្រីក៏វាអាចប្រើជាឧបករណ៍មួយដើម្បីគ្រប់គ្រងថ្នាក់រៀនដែរដោយថាមានភាពរញ៉េរញ៉ៃអញ្ចឹងទៅយើងហៅកុមារឲ្យមកច្រៀងរាំអីឡើងវិញអញ្ចឹងទៅដើម្បីឲ្យកុមារហ្នឹងអាចមានបំរុងបញ្ញត្តិអញ្ចឹងវាអាចប្រើជាឧបករណ៍មួយដើម្បីគ្រប់គ្រងថ្នាក់រៀនក៏បានដែរអាហ្នឹងចំឡោយបងគាត់អញ្ចឹងណាអញ្ចឹងវាអត់មាន rule ថាប្រើម៉ោងមុនម៉ោងក្រោយអីទេបាទ
Any other comments or questions about the presentation today?
ចឹងមានសំណួរឬក៏មានអនុសាសន៍អីបពេញបន្ថែមទៀតទេបាទ
And there is a person who wrote something on the chat so come right now
about the play but the topic today the day is talk about the music but she asked about how big group and small group big play group and big small group and small play group which one is important. I think she's good in English. Why she just write in Khmer? Should be write in English also?
Yes. Both are important, I would say, right? So it depends on the purpose, right? So I guess both, and play is very connected to music as well, right? So, and children can really investigate, explore. Small groups or large groups. Right? So, all right. So just let me also say, Sokom, how I normally also finish my class. And also, especially when I'm teaching music class, I always end with a goodbye song. All of the students coming to my classes, I always do the same thing. So I would always play a goodbye song to say goodbye to everybody. So let me, because it's almost time to go. I will play the goodbye song first, and then Sahid will be playing the slides of the department to say goodbye to everybody more formally, right? So,
ចង់ជាឲ្យលោកស្រីថាថ្នាក់របស់គាត់គឺចាប់ដើមឡើងដោយតន្ត្រីហើយបញ្ចប់ទៅវិញដោយតន្ត្រីដែរអញ្ចឹងគាត់នឹងលេងចាក់តន្ត្រី goodbye song នេះមកបត់ហើយនឹងបកគោលទូនាទីទៅឲ្យលោកសាហិតដើម្បីបញ្ចប់បាទខ្ញុំសូមអរគុណច្រើនដែលថាយើងពេលវេលាយើងតិចបាទអរគុណ
Very good. Thanks for coming. All right.
Okay. Thank you, Alfredo. Thank you so much for sharing your knowledge and wisdom. And I hope our participants will find it useful in teaching their preschools. And let's go to, let me just thank you formally from behalf of the department as well as from the participants' behalf that we are grateful for your time and knowledge and your input and for sharing valuable techniques and tools for teachers to practice in their actual classrooms in Cambodia. I hope they will find it useful. And I am also grateful to our team members from Cambodia, Nick and Soxocom, for help and support and coordination and facilitating us in conducting or organizing these workshops. And also, I'm thankful to Casey, our team member, who has been very helpful in terms of technical input.
Chung môn nâng bật chóp cư nhóm xôm mà thay nó con krom ca nghĩa đại miên nhóm hay nâng ngách đại trên nhà sổ sổ nông ca riêng chóm sạch hà sạ là ní hay xôm ô con được đo là nhà khai si viên đại có trên nhà sổ sổ đá càng rõ tùm báo nơi nông ca riêng chóm sạch hà sạ là ní bạn.
Thank you, Sokom. Thank you again. Please do not forget to leave your feedback. It's very valuable for us, and it will help us organize the topics and workshops you really need for teaching in the classrooms or any other education area. So please give us your feedback. We really value it. And please do not forget to register for the next upcoming workshop next year, January 14th.
Okay. Chúng xong rồi lực alo sợi của mọi lịch ao anh ở sát này con ông tầm nọ hay được gọi ông cột ba cột ní của anh ở sát hay nâng mình tệ giúp bò cài làm alo sợi bật chìm biển sạt sông khăn trong cài điệp chom khai sạt là bò bùa dương khi nhom hay xong rồi lực mà cho nói mùi tiền đấy xong alo sợi cùng lịch cho chúng mua trong cài cho luôn sạt khai sạt là nơi vẽ cối cứ nơi ngày thì đập buôn khai mà cả ra chín năm thì còn một phẩy bảy.
And you can know more about tour activities of our department and the university through various channels mentioned here. So thank you again. For now, it's time to say goodbye. And thank you so much for joining us in this workshop. We wish you very nice and wonderful weekend and see you next year and have a nice and wonderful new year again.
Som thlai mong kon da lo srei dai ban jamnai pe chou ruom neu knong vyak sakha sala ba jeung ni hai som oy chun po lo srei a chuop teah ta samnang lo hai chuop khnie neu chnam kroy neu knong sikha sala vyak kroy tiet ba. Happy new year. Thank you, Alfredo Sahit.
Thank you very much. Have a nice
day. Bye bye.